Hello everyone, this is Bran, the Random Gamer.
Someone's outside dancing.
Not alone, but here with my friends to bring back sort of a series I started back in 2011, which was My Thoughts series, which I did a little short video about my thoughts about Sonic 4 Episode 2. Granted, that was back when I was young and less complicated of a person. And yes, educated. Thank you, Anna. And also, this time we actually got to see or the product we will be reviewing or stating our opinions of. If you couldn't already tell by the title of this video, we just got back, well, not really, from seeing The Amazing Spider-Man 2 about 2 days ago. We would have done this the day of, but unfortunately, due to someone messing up our bus transit plans, we weren't able to do it the day of. But however, I think the movie's still fresh in our minds. Am I right?
Yes.
So, well, basically, we'll be talking about not only our thoughts on this movie, but I guess not into the extent of too much of the original movies, but we'll be comparing as well. And while we do so, I'll be playing the original Amazing Spider-Man game. Unfortunately, I do not own the Amazing Spider-Man 2 game that just was released earlier this week. But, you know, money's a problem and all that stuff. Ain't nobody got money for that.
The struggle is real.
Not true fan.
But anyways, I'll start. Well, I already said I'm Brandon Random Gamer.
Yeah, if you guys don't already know. It's me. Yeah, the awesome.
And I'm Adam Sadiki.
And it's Black.
You might want to speak louder. The poor fans want to hear you.
It's Black Colin.
Oh, no, isn't your name like Sky Attacker of the Winged Soldier?
No, that's Annan. That's Sky Shot.
Sky Shot, right.
Anyways, yes, there's not going to be a playthrough of this, The Amazing Spider-Man game. We're just going to be talking over our thoughts and opinions of the movies. So let's start off with our thoughts on the original Amazing Spider-Man. What did you guys think about it?
It was alright.
It was terrible.
Okay, one at a time, Yaya. The negative critic, or the bad critic, we like to say.
It was terrible in every single regard. They totally messed up his character. So, when he was first starting out, he just didn't have the whole Spider-Man thing down. Like, it didn't feel like Spider-Man. It felt like some... Because Spider-Man is supposed to be smart and stuff, right? And... He's supposed to
be... You're talking out of your ass. You do know that, right?
No,
Peter Parker is supposed to be smart. Peter Parker.
Yes, he is.
Yeah.
I didn't like the fact that Andrew Garfield stuttered more than, like, Shia LaBeouf in Transformers. I mean, that's true. If you watch the movie, he stutters a lot.
Well, that's kind of Peter Parker's character in the same way as well.
Peter Parker's shy. But he's also smart.
But he didn't get more confidence. You know, as he has his powers, he gets more confident.
No shit.
But okay, let's pretend I don't know the actor's name who plays him.
Where am I?
And then now you tell me the actor's name who plays him.
Andrew Garfield.
Yes, Andrew Garfield did not do a good job portraying that. That Peter Parker is supposed to be smart. He portrayed him more as just like super aloof. Guy who like skates all day and stuff, and it didn't portray his character well, in my opinion.
Well, so, I like to like argue against Yaya about that claim, but the thing is,
likes to argue against
yes,
Yaya
but the thing
claim.
Is, I can't really defend my opinion that much because the whole movie, in my opinion, was forgettable.
Extreme,
in comparison to the first Spider-Man movie,
especially,
I'm talking about the Sam Raimi version.
Especially about you know the last scene thing with the person shooting Spider-Man.
The person
in the leg.
Shooting.
Oh, okay. We're gonna be doing spoilers in these
retrospectives. Okay, we're expecting by now all the fans out there have actually seen the first movie.
The first one,
then
at least.
Why would you be watching this? Right?
Would you probably say?
Spoiler alert.
Yes, but we will be doing a non-spoiler review of Amazing Spider-Man 2 as well, but. In case you haven't seen the first...
spoiler review, it was good. Go watch it. There we go.
Okay, yeah, end of story. But
seriously, we can't really talk
okay,
about
but before
it
we go into that, Bilal, what do you think about the first movie? Because apparently you have a different opinion from us.
Does he actually?
His opinion is Emma Stone is hot.
Yes, but...
The first one... Which
I agree with, by the way.
That makes you try.
Good job.
Wait, which first one are we talking about?
The first one.
We're talking about The Amazing Spider-Man.
I actually like the first one better than the second one. Because the second one, I think the second one was misinterpreting. Like, I think there were too many characters in the second one.
Okay. We're not on the second one yet.
In the first one, there was only like one villain, and the second one there was like three kind of. Rhino really didn't care.
Rhino didn't. Okay, that's spoilers. Okay, shut up. Sorry, people.
Okay, can we just get opinion? Yeah. What's your opinion of the first one?
The Amazing Spider-Man, that is.
I liked it. I liked it that Gwen Stacy's story was told.
Okay.
You liked that Gwen Stacy's
because the original one with Tobey Maguire didn't tell anything about Gwen Stacy.
Okay, but she wasn't in the... Okay, no, that's true. Some fans like, or at least claim to like the Amazing series better just because it's somehow closer to the comics. And while that is somewhat slightly true...
Oh, is it closer to the comics?
In some ways it is, but not all of them. Like, for example, in the Sam Raimi trilogy, Toby had organic web shooters. Like, it came from his body.
True.
Yeah, it's true. And in the Amazing series, he has the web shooters. Like...
Okay, but... See, I would argue, but then I'd be spoiling the second.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay.
Okay, I'm going to argue that later and just put that on the.
Okay, bro. Just don't like jump around in the city. Like, actually do something.
And then shut up. I think this is one of the problems about the games. Completely unrelated. But once you complete all the missions, there's not even crimes you can do. So you know what? I'm gonna go back to the apartment. Yeah. It's not like the original Spider-Man 2 movie game where crimes just happen at random. It's just mission oriented.
Yeah. Didn't you know that in cities where you kill everyone, there's no crimes.
Yep.
If you kill all
exactly.
The, kill all the bad guys.
It stops one time.
It just stops.
Cause good people just can't turn bad off a sudden.
Hey, look, I'm swinging from the clouds.
Try to attack the helicopter.
Oh wait. Okay. While we're
moving back.
Actually, something before we talk about even the second movie was what was your thoughts on the original three Spider-Man movies?
The third one I didn't like, I gotta say. Dr. Octopus just didn't seem very Dr. Octopus.
That's the second one.
The third one was
Venom.
Yeah, the third one was Sandman. The third one was amazing. I liked the third one a lot.
Really?
The third one sucked.
Are you different serious? Different opinion alert.
I'll explain why in a second. No.
Okay, let's start with the original Spider-Man, though.
The original?
Yeah, like the one with the Green Goblin.
I liked it a lot.
Me too. It was good, I thought it was way better than the Amazing Spider-Man.
It opened the series up really, really well, to be completely honest.
Yeah, I like the way Uncle Ben died in that one. Not to say I enjoyed death, but it was barely... I thought it was done better than in the original... Amazing Spider-Man.
It was done really well.
And
Tobey Maguire did a really good job...
Crying.
He did a really good job of portraying Peter Parker's character.
Yeah. Well, that's half of the character. No shit.
But he cried a lot.
Okay, he showed the emotional
spectrum because Spider-Man, no one's, like, he's a man, he's human.
He's a man.
But he was too much of a wuss. You know what I'm saying?
I'm sorry, when your uncle died, did you...
I know, but, like, later on, like, in the series, like, he was way too much of a
wuss. We're on the first one, though, right?
Yeah.
Okay, fine.
The first one.
Okay, the first one. Yeah, the first one was fine. I liked it.
That's kind of what made it better as well, the villain choice. Like, Green Goblin's just a better villain than the Lizard in general.
Oh, no, Green Goblin is like... When people think of Batman, they think of Joker. When people think of Spider-Man, they think Green Goblin.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, no one thinks of Lizard. Like, they think Green Goblin, they think Doc Ock, they think New Goblin. They don't think Lizard.
Yeah, I know. He's more like a side villain that you saved for the movie.
Lizard is really...
They think
Sucky
Venom.
As a villain?
Yes.
They think Venom.
They think Carnage.
Yes.
Yeah. Actually, like the Green Goblin in the first one.
Yeah.
The costume was really nice.
Yeah, I know. Some people hated the costume because it kind of was like, what's the word? It's, overdone. Like, it's over the top.
The costume wasn't a problem for me. It was, I don't know, it could have been done better.
Yeah.
Like, it's not really that much of a spoiler, but the...
No, you can tell spoilers for the original trilogy. I'm sorry, but if you haven't seen it by now, you get out of here right now.
No, not the original. Exactly. I want to say, okay, then the Green Goblin in the newest movie.
In the second one.
Yeah, is that
really okay. Don't talk about this.
But his character design.
His character design. Yeah, okay, you can talk about the character design.
It's the character design of Green Goblin in the newest Spider-Man, Amazing Spider-Man 2, is just really, really good, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It just really portrays his character very well.
He looks more... psychotic.
Uh-huh. Exactly. He actually looks crazy.
Yeah.
So I really like it.
Mm.
And so I didn't have a problem per se with the original portrayal.
Yeah.
But just the new portrayal is just much better.
Yeah. However, then again, Yeah, it's hard to get not to get into spoilers because I have to mention something that. Well, all I got to say is the original Goblin in the first movie, who was played by Willem Dafoe. God bless him, because he did a freaking awesome portrayal. Because back then, that was the closest we got to like a crazy villain before the Joker in Dark Knight.
Yeah, yeah.
So he kind of like set the bar. And of course, I'm not gonna lie, I'm a Spider-Man fan, but obviously, who's the actor who did the Joker in the freaking? Heath Ledger was obviously better. But like he, Willem Dafoe really set the bar for. Green Goblin. I thought he did great.
First crazy psychotic villains.
Yeah.
His laugh. Holy.
I know.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Anyways, I thought the first movie was great. I like the fact that he didn't take him like 3 years to get him to make him be Spider-Man, because in The Amazing Spider-Man it took like a freaking hour.
Yeah.
To become Spider-Man. So it was a lot of just Peter screen time. So overall thoughts, we like the original first Spider-Man.
Yes. Moving on to the second one.
The second one is my favorite, still is to this day.
I did not even like over the second one.
Really?
No.
Why? Why did you not like it, Raya?
I didn't like it because Doc Ock just seemed not very Doc. He's this genius supervillain.
Scientist.
Yeah, okay, fine. I'm talking about Doc Ock. Fine. Okay, we can go ahead and talk about him as a scientist. He's this genius scientist, and he can't... I don't know.
More like mad scientist, actually, really.
And he can't control his own, like, arm things.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. It could have been done much better, his transformation. Mm-hmm. It just seemed really rushed and really... Mm-hmm. I don't know. It just seemed really bad. Like, one second, he's a scientist who has the love of his life. He's like, he's married to some woman. He's giving Peter Parker woman advice. He's on top of the world as a scientist and stuff. And then the next second, he's robbing banks.
Well, yeah.
And they only credited that to the fact that the inhibition chip broke.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I mean, yeah. Also, when the thing started to go off, I mean... The guy was a little stupid. I mean, he's a genius level scientist, but he's a little stupid. Like, he should have turned it off.
Regardless, he was going to have to turn into him eventually.
Yeah, yeah, no. I'm not saying that he shouldn't have turned into him.
Yeah.
I'm just saying
story progression, but the way he turned into Doc Ock was a little stupid because it kind of went against his entire character of being very, very smart individual. You know?
Well, the reason why I like the second one a lot is because they kind of introduced a lot of new characters. Jonah was already in the first one. I gotta say, J. Jonah Jameson, I forgot the actor who plays him, is a freaking incredible. In fact, I do not know how they're gonna replace him in the series. Not really spoiler, but he's not in The Amazing Spider-Man 2. He's mentioned, but he's not.
Email.
Yes, yeah. In the email, but he's. Because they're probably trying to find the freaking actor to replace him still.
To replace him.
Yeah, you can't replace that. He's like, he is Jay Jonason.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, like really, the insults that he throws at Peter.
Yeah.
It's hilarious.
They're so,
and
so
he's such
real.
Such a quick talker. It's hilarious.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's so natural for him to do that role.
Yeah. But anyways, I also like the apartment
he's
scenes.
He's a natural asshole, what we're trying to say.
But also, like, when going back to 2, I also like how they incorporated, like, the apartment scenes with, the guy who always keeps asking him to pay the rent. Like, that was always funny. Oh. Mr. Grekovich, I think that was his name or something.
To be completely honest, maybe it's not that I didn't like the second movie, I just didn't like Doc Ock's portrayal.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's fair enough.
As a movie,
the fight scenes, the train and everything, that was pretty cool.
Yeah, the fight scenes, the action was, like, the best. Like, I thought there was, like, the perfect mix of...
The final scenes.
Yeah, I thought there was a perfect mix of both character development and like action. Like Peter goes like I'd say a quarter of the movie without being Spider-Man because that's like the whole gimmick. Like, is he naturally supposed to be Spider-Man or not? And I thought the moral of the story was great. Like that scene with Aunt May when they're talking about like becoming a hero and you know the only thing I could say that I really despised slightly about Spider-Man 2 was the train scene at the end of it when he had to reveal. Like, his identity to all those people. Like, everyone's not gonna, like, tell that he's, like, Spider-Man. That's kind
of... I call bullshit on that. At least one person out of all those people.
I'm going to the gym.
Possibly told someone.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay, no, but when you think about it, even if one person told someone...
No one believe,
No, Peter Parker's kind of a nobody.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
I mean, no one really knows him.
Yeah.
But it does kind of make sense. I mean, he's the only guy who can possibly get Spidey pictures in the
Yeah, you kind of...
I mean...
And I'm referring.
And if you actually look at those pictures, there's some really good damn close-up pictures that only, like, if you really think about it, only Spider-Man can take.
Or someone who uses Photoshop.
They're basically selfies.
Someone uses Photoshop. Yeah. To go back on to the first movie, but remember the wrestling guy who wouldn't give him his money? He would probably know him too. It was like, no one would believe me.
Exactly. You're wearing the Spider-Man, like, emblem.
Yeah.
Right.
If he didn't take off his mask, fair enough, but he did.
Yeah, he did.
So yeah, there's a little bit of a...
Also, the thief. He took off his mask when he was facing the thief.
But the thief died.
Yeah, the thief died.
So makes sense. Anyways, so I really liked the second one. I thought it had a great balance of both storytelling and action scenes. I really liked the moral too, because by the end of it, you feel like, you know, you feel all tingly, and at least for me, you know, I like... Yeah. You know, the stresses of being a hero while trying to manage your life and all that. Because you could tell, you know, in the end, he couldn't, like, always be with Mary Jane without the danger. Also, I gotta say this while we're referring to the both of the series. I love, I do like Emma Stone as Gwen Stacy way better than Kristen Dunst, I believe, for Mary Jane in the original series. Because Mary Jane didn't do crap. Barely anything.
Yeah, yeah. Emma Stone was basically the damsel in distress.
Yes. Yeah. And while
all three movies.
Yes, exactly. And while Gwen Stacy, of course, does that sometimes, she does take action like in the freaking new movies.
You know that she you can see that she's a genius. And she does help him.
And that does happen in the second movie for those wondering.
It even happens in this game that we're playing.
Yes. Like,
She basically like saves humanity with that cure thing. You know.
Oh yeah. Spoiler for the game, by the way. I know some people may not have played it yet. But too late for that.
They even introduced Gwen Stacy's character in the second one, right? Well, what's the third one?
What? Oh yeah. Oh, Gwen Stacy in the third one sucked. But wait, any other thoughts about Spider-Man 2 while we're before we move on to that one?
I think it's a tie for me.
No.
The first one
for me personally, it's my favorite movie, in, so far anyways. Released. Who knows in the future?
I like it too. I give it like a 75 out of 100.
What the fuck? I for me personally, I never give star ratings or freaking number ratings, because in the end, you just want to know if you should see it or not.
Yeah.
Or if you should rent it.
You should definitely see the old series so you can tell where Spider-Man, how much.
Even Spider-Man 3.
Yeah,
we'll get into that right now, I guess, if anyone else has anything left.
I'll give it potato out of tomato.
I love these stealth takedowns. But anyways, to Spider-Man 3, okay. This is everyone's,
The Phantom Menace of the Spider-Man series.
Yes, but, in my opinion, I do agree that it's, I don't think it's underrated, but I think it's overhated, if that makes any sense. Like, because, yes, there was a lot of missed opportunities, and I was disappointed at first, but I thought the action scenes were still great. Granted, I think Venom was pointless to add, because he only got... So very little screen time.
Also,
and
I didn't
Topher Grace as freaking Venom was a freaking waste of potential.
Also,
as well.
I didn't get why Venom every 2 minutes took off
his freaking his mask.
His face.
I just wanted to see Venom's mask because it did look cool.
Exactly.
I don't want to see freaking Topher Grace's face.
Exactly.
I just want to see like freaking Venom.
Yeah.
You know?
I thought
just like that long tongue, that ugly smile. You know.
Yes, yeah, we're not talking about the game. I haven't played this in a while, by the way, so I apologize if I suck a lot.
I still haven't finished the game.
What the frick?
Yeah.
Not a true fan in here. Oh, no one was there.
Hey, at least I own the game, unlike some people.
So, it's a unanimous opinion between between both of you that the third movie sucks.
Sandman, what do you
guys
think about
I thought Sandman was good, but it should have been focused more on him.
I think Sandman was the best part of that movie.
Yeah.
Sandman's character design, his character development, his actor, it was just really,
Sandman was introduced, it was a good one.
Yeah, I love the transformation, like the transforming scene with the sand. It was really similar to kind of how they did the molecules.
Except
thing.
That locket right. that he carries around. Like
yeah,
that
makes sense.
Was like, why didn't that get destroyed? You know.
Who cares? No one. If you're gonna question stuff like that, you might as well question like the whole series in general. Like, just starting from the first comic, Amazing Fantasy 15, I believe.
I don't know. In my opinion, I just really liked it because...
Bro, just like stand up and fight them, man. Come
it's
on.
Not... No, I'm on hard mode, so if I like standing and get hit too much...
The character
I forgot. How do you dodge?
You dodge... Oh, yeah. I play PC version.
Okay,
and
then, please. The character design was really good. The action was really good.
Yeah.
I liked Sandman a lot. Sandman was really good.
Yeah.
I hated Harry Osborn. Who was Harry Osborn's...
James Franco.
I hated James Franco.
And, by the way, did you catch, like, that scandal thing about him, like, dating, like, a freaking 16-year-old or something?
Oh, yeah, yeah. James Franco was, like... Just he acted exactly like Spider-Man. He was way too emotional for Harry Osborn.
No, I thought he was great in the second movies. It's just
movie he was a wimp.
It was kind of weird.
Okay, in my opinion, and we're gonna get more into this when we start the review of the second one.
Mm-hmm.
But the newest. Who's the actor for the newest Harry Osborn?
I forgot his name. To be honest, I do not know, but he was great.
British guy was really good. He had a British accent.
Oh, he's Andrew Garfield. He's like freaking England guy. Our Andrew Garfield is United Kingdom, right? Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's not
UK,
American.
He's UK.
Yeah, he's UK. Yeah, so yeah, United Kingdom. No one cares about that. Okay, so yeah.
I just... find that Harry Osborn wasn't the best. He wasn't the worst Harry Osborn.
No.
But he wasn't the best either.
Yeah.
So they could have done Harry Osborn much better.
Mm-hmm.
But that wasn't the problem that I had. The problem that I had was Venom again.
Yeah.
Venom's actor was terrible.
Yeah.
In terrible. Every regard. Yeah. Venom is supposed to be like.
Yeah,
Venom is big. Venom is badass even before he turns into Venom.
Yeah. Yes. And he works out. He lifts, exactly. Bro. Bro, he does lift.
Exactly.
Exactly.
And they never portrayed that properly.
Yeah.
They never portrayed that properly. Venom is supposed to be like super cool.
Mm-hmm.
But they never show that in the movie. Like, they show him as some wimpy guy who, like, finds a symbiotic alien who attaches himself.
He just gets lucky.
Exactly.
Up all night to get lucky. Yeah, he goes to the church. They got the church scene right, but...
Oh, yeah, they got that.
Yeah, but also, isn't it a huge coincidence that he goes to the exact same church that Peter Parker happens to, like,
Yeah, but that's, like, in the freaking comics, I mean. That's
Not, like, and there's only one.
There has to be some continuity.
Okay, fine.
There's only one church in the city, Adnan.
Yeah, you know, one Catholic church in the whole city.
One church in the entire
it's just really
York
huge
in Manhattan.
Yeah. Was I supposed to take a photo of this? As I said before, it's been a while.
Take a photo, man. Take a photo.
How do you freaking take a photo?
Yeah, but the actor... wasn't good.
No,
yeah, the character development wasn't good. Nothing about Venom was good, except the character design.
I do. Like, when I saw, like, his face, for example, but it was always freaking, like, getting peeled off to, like, show Topher Grace standing.
Exactly. I bet he just asked the director, can I have more face time, please?
Yeah, the casting decision, like, as soon as he's not, like, a big guy, or if he's not willing to, like, work out to those extremes, don't hire him for that role.
He just didn't do a very good job at Venom.
But the whole concept about Spider-Man 3 was about the black suit and how it was like a drug addiction for like Peter. And I love that concept. That is like a good story plot. It's just that it's hard to take it seriously when Peter Parker's like walking down freaking New York, like trying to hit on women and dancing randomly in the freaking streets.
What's the most lamest dance moves ever?
I like those dance moves. Like, I kind of emulate that today.
So you
but
dig
I dig it, but as I said before, it's freaking stupid and ruins the whole, like, are we supposed to feel sorry for Peter?
He goes emo.
While I like Peter Parker's Tobey Maguire, right?
Mm-hmm,
I like Tobey Maguire, he didn't do a very good job portraying the whole black suit thing.
Yeah, in the third one, yes, I agree.
He didn't do a very good job. But the thing I liked about Spider-Man 3 wasn't Tobey Maguire and it definitely wasn't Venom, because Venom was terrible.
Yeah. You like Sandman.
I really liked Sandman, and my point earlier, I didn't like Harry Osborn, but in the third movie, Harry Osborn was really good as the new Goblin.
Yeah, yeah.
So, I really liked Sandman, and I really liked New Goblin.
And sorry guys for just swinging around here, I forgot what there should be like some, like, freaking wheel to, like, spin.
Yeah, it's right there.
Where? No,
just
that's
go,
like a...
Just go Spidey Vision and find it. That's how you find things in this game.
What's
Spidey Vision?
I forgot even the button. Oh, there it is. Okay. and Gwen Stacy does not even match even close to freaking Emma Stone standard.
Oh, yeah, no.
Like,
Gwen Stacy
is a dumbass.
Before you guys mentioned Gwen Stacy was in the movie, I didn't even know she was. She was.
It was forgettable. Yeah.
Yeah, of course,
there's like the jazz dancing club scene.
Oh my god.
This is a Spider-Man movie. But like I said before, the action scenes are done great. Even with Venom, I like the action scenes with him as well. It was just a missed opportunity. I don't think it was like bad to the point where I wouldn't want to watch it at least once. But it was disappointing. I do feel it's overhated, but You know, it had some good moments. Just a lot of missed potential. If they just focused on the black story arc, black story arc, the black suit story
racist.
Arc. Racist! Yeah, I know.
They had two really good story arcs in there, which was Sandman, and they had... No, three, sorry. Sandman, mm-hmm. Harry Osborn, and Peter Parker.
Mm-hmm.
And they didn't focus on they didn't focus on any of them properly enough.
Yeah.
They kind of, like, split up the scene time, and it ended up each one being mediocre-ish.
Uh-huh.
But I still liked it.
But one last thing to just close off talking about the original trilogy. Do you believe that it could have continued off of it if there wasn't any legal reasons? Yes, I believe so, too.
Definitely.
Maybe. Yeah.
Yeah. Even with Harry dying and all, I think they could have, like, they'd probably bring Carnage or something.
Yeah, Carnage would have been a good... Carnage would be a good...
Yeah. Or they might... I was talking about this earlier off-screen, but also the Ben Reilly storyline, I think they could have actually started to introduce as well.
And they could have done a lot of stuff, because they didn't explore a lot of... none of the movies have explored a lot of the comics so far. So.
Yeah. It's just, there's so much more potential.
Yeah.
And that's what I'm hoping for. Even the two new movies kind of miss on some aspects in that regard. It goes all around, you know. It's all hit and miss. However, I really liked the first two movies, and the third one was meh, but I liked some parts of it. Bilal, what was your thoughts? Because you barely saw anything. Just the whole original trilogy as a whole.
The first and second one would be a tie for me. The third one, I didn't like it that much, but I did like it, but not as much as the first and second.
And then?
Same with Bilal, man. Same as Bilal. I didn't like... the third one as much as the first and second. My favorite would have been the first one.
Interesting.
So
Blood, your favorite is the first two, right?
Yeah.
Okay, Yaya, last but not least. Certainly not least. Oh, dang, freaking asshole.
I really like the first one, and I really like the third one. My favorite has to be a tie between the first and third.
Unpopular opinion alert.
I didn't hate the second one by any means. I really liked it. It just wasn't the best for me.
Alright.
I was like, eh.
Oh, one big...
I just really didn't like Doc Ock.
Okay.
One big critical thing that we forgot to mention about the entire series of the first Spider-Man.
So the first three movies.
The first three movies was the very, very long introduction thing. The
opening credits?
The opening credits.
I freaking disagree with that. I love that part of the movie. The music score for those scenes was incredible. I love the music.
I definitely don't have a problem with
that. Yeah, I love those. Oh my gosh. I love the music score in that trilogy. The opening music. I love that. So, and an unpopular opinion on those.
That was really good. Yeah.
I love those opening sequences. Score for those movies, by the way. You know, I know it's really nerdy to talk about the music in a freaking movie, but I love that opening theme.
Yeah,
the third one, they added like a darkness thing to match the black suit atmosphere, and I loved it. You know, it was like a little bit of a recap each time. Like in the third one, they did a little cool recap. You know, some people might think that's a waste of screen time, but I think it's a nice little touch to get everyone back.
I like Quick Question. What's the scene of the movie?
Hey, look, the guys.
Look at the guy's seizure! Oh, he stopped. Wait.
Oh, okay.
No. A flashback of that.
That's ragdoll.
Ragdoll physics. Anyways, yes, but sorry, what are you saying?
You know how often I've been trying to move anyway, right? There's a scene.
The first movie to do that in the Marvel series, I believe, was Iron Man, one.
It was Iron Man with the Avengers.
Yes, that's when the company had the right to do it with Captain America, the Hulk, blah, 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 blah. And that's when they brought up... Wait, was it Captain America or was it... Not Captain America. Was it the Iron Man or the freaking first Hulk, the reboot Hulk, not the original?
Oh, it might have been Hulk. Was Hulk before Iron Man?
I think so, 2007 or 8.
I'm pretty sure it was Hulk. Yeah. Why is it that Hulk was before Hulk got the scene at the end? And they haven't explored Hulk in any of the Avenger movies yet. They have.
Yeah, they have.
No, sorry, my bad. I was thinking about...
You're
going to
go right into Venom?
Something I actually should mention is that technically the first trilogy of... So the Sam Raimi movies, the ones with the Tobey Maguire, are technically not the first ever Spider-Man movies. I know, right? There was a series, I believe, in the 80s, or at least one movie. That was really extremely cheesy that I bothered to look up YouTube. if you're a really hardcore Spider-Man true fan, you might wanna see it. Dang it, freaking. And that's why you freaking have to do the freaking invasions. But yeah, it was extremely cheesy, and of course it's outdated. But yeah, it's not the first ever movie. I do not recommend watching it unless you can tolerate really old school retro things.
Hey, real hardcore fans would have.
Yes, and I did it. I viewed it. I watched it on YouTube.
No, not you. Not in the game. The real hardcore fans wouldn't have died there.
Oh, shut up.
Just saying.
I haven't played this game in ages.
I'm kidding, man.
I don't even know how you freaking dodge. I think you just jump randomly.
See, real hardcore fans would know how to dodge and jump.
Shut up, Ben.
Yeah, whatever. Shut up, Ben. You haven't even beat the game yet.
Yeah, I know. I'm just trolling. Never mind.
Where's the freaking... but yeah, so we're done talking about the old trilogy.
Thank God.
We kind of started talking about the first movie, but we kind of got cut off as soon as we started talking about... Dang it, I'm gonna die if I don't do anything.
You should stop jumping in the sewage.
Yes.
That's what you should stop doing.
Well, this is sewage, but whatever. Anyways,
sewage for some reason hurt you. It's weird.
Radioactive.
The other sewage was radioactive, that's why.
Yeah. Anyways, so back to the first Amazing Spider-Man movie that came out in 2012, I believe. They're pulling the same thing they did with the original trilogy, because the first one came out in 2002, then Spider-Man 2 in 2004. However, the Amazing Spider-Man 3 is going to come out in 2016, I believe.
Yeah, May 26th.
Yeah, again, the third one came out in 2007.
They already have the date down and everything?
Yeah, and they already had the fourth one, yeah. Planned
really?
Out. Yeah.
No.
Yes.
I heard that the Spider-Man has a 3-year contract with
that
thing.
Yeah, but they already announced the date for the fourth one. It's in 2018.
Really?
So they already have plans for that. But yeah, anyways, back to our thoughts about the original movie. Like I said,
of Amazing Spider-Man.
Yeah, okay. It's hard. We all know that once you start something new, it's hard to accept new changes and all that crap. You know, some people, there's always going to be the people that are like too retro to accept anything new, and vice versa. The newest, youngest generation say, yeah, this is cool, this is the crap. You know, screw off you oldies, you know.
I kind of like that they tried to do a new universe of Spider-Man, that they didn't try to remake
the Star Wars
old,
the prequels. Hey, I like the third one.
Okay,
I like the third one.
The second and third one were fine.
But okay,
it's
May the 4th, so let's have
Phantom Menace.
Okay, are we good? Is this like a Spider-Man? with the great... small little note, I guess we should say. This is being done on May 4th, which is, you know... Star Wars Day.
Yeah.
And we're talking about Spider-Man. Who would have ever thought? But yeah.
What a dodge. Pro dodge right there.
Yeah, scripted team.
My favorite movie was Phantom Menace, what?
Dude, okay.
I'm kidding.
No, he's not.
Yeah, I know.
Actually loves Phantom Menace.
Phantom Menace, and which one was the sixth one?
Okay, guys, we're going to have to change the title of this freaking thing. But don't worry, okay, continue on with our thoughts about Star Wars. Today's Star Wars Day.
The title is now,
Thoughts about Spider-Man plus Star Wars.
Spider-Stars.
Spider-Wars.
Yes.
Spider-Wars.
Spider Wars.
What's the sixth Star Wars movie?
Are you talking about the old trilogy or?
It's the sixth.
In the series,
The third of the old.
Oh, so that's Return of the Jedi.
Yes, Return of the Jedi. My favorite ones are Return of the Jedi and Phantom Menace. Not because of anything, just because in the end it gets really happy and it's like all the atmosphere, the atmosphere changes a lot and everyone's like, oh, hail the conquering hero.
Yeah, you realize you have like the most unpopular opinions ever.
Yeah,
oh, no,
probably,
I realize.
No, that's fine. Just prepare for like the comment section,
yes,
like
exactly.
They're like piss on you. This is Vermin, by the way. Do you think they would ever put him in the movies? Probably not.
Please not.
No.
Please.
No. He's too much of a...
Yeah, he's too unpopular.
I beat this guy in at least, like, the first go.
Yeah.
He's very easy.
Were you playing on superhero mode?
What?
Granted, superhero mode is not even that hard.
I was playing on hero.
Oh, well, you're lame, then. Anyone could be on hero.
Hey. At least I wasn't playing...
I really, really, really hope they don't put Vermin in the movie. Because he just sucks so much.
See the controls, because I'm tired of not knowing what the freak how to dodge.
Vermin is worse than Lizard in that regard.
Yeah, he is, yeah. Oh, so triangle, thank God. You see, I never pressed triangle. So yes, kids, always go to the option menus to see the controls. Anyways, yes. So can we talk about the first Amazing Spider-Man movie?
I like how they made it a bit funny.
The first one.
Yeah.
Spider-Man.
The Spider-Man was a lot more funny in that movie. Yeah. Granted, not to say there was any jokes in the original trilogy, but they made him have more jokes and all that.
They missed out on the whole, like, watch Spider-Man out. And superheroes in general are supposed to be like, if you, this isn't really much of a spoiler, so let's say Spider-Man was going up against, what's his face, Electro. Mm-hmm. Like, he'd say, oh, that was shocking.
Yeah, he did say... That we ain't talking about the second movie, no. But there's not one electric pun in the whole freaking movie.
Not one.
Yeah, he calls them Shocky or something. Shocker. No.
Sparkles.
Sparkles, yes. Sparkles, but that's not freaking a pun, yeah. So that doesn't count. So I am disappointed.
Yeah, I didn't like it. I did not like it.
I like how.
Besides that, the movie was electrifying.
Dang it, man! How do you?
Adnan, how do you come up with these things?
No, more like Adnan, how do you live with yourself?
I like the Batman, how they made a movie like Batman Begins, like how they made it.
What Bilal's referring to is that how they made the series a little bit more dark. I don't think Spider-Man needs to be too dark.
It wasn't really that dark.
Yeah, it wasn't that dark. They were playing on the whole...
The police officer died and everything.
Yeah.
Gwen's dad died, and it was like, oh, no.
Yeah. Not enough really people died in Batman, I think. Not enough people
We need
died.
To see more death in Batman. Oh, by the way, Dark Knight Rises is overrated.
I agree, Dark Knight Rises
is overrated. Yeah. Now it's Spider-Man Wars.
I liked it.
I really
like
Bat
Spider
Wars.
Oh yeah, now it's freaking Batman.
Okay. I'm Batman as Brandon is with Spider-Man. I've read like most of the comics. So I'm like super hardcore.
Yeah. I guess we should clarify. I'm really hardcore with Spider-Man. He's like, as I said before, he's my favorite superhero. So I know everything regarding TV shows, comics, you know, video games too. So I'm really hardcore in that sense, but I can only say that for Spider-Man.
I've read some of Amazing Spider-Man up to Gwen Stacy.
I'm hardcore with Spoiler! Batman.
And we're gonna edit that out now.
So
yes.
Everyone knew.
Okay, now go.
I'm hardcore with Batman, but I have read the other comics, and I know most of the DC. Most of the DC universe, actually, like the whole thing with the Justice League, which is much better than the Avengers, by the way.
Hey, no, I disagree.
Yeah, totally
I
better.
If you have Superman in the freaking group, it's too OP, so it's too mainstream.
Oh, please! Like Superman doesn't even beat what's his face?
Thor?
No. What?
Thor.
No.
God of Thunder.
They're not in the same
No, we're talking
universe.
About Justice League, though.
I thought you were making comparison with powerful.
If we're talking about comparison, Justice League,
Sonny Rat.
What's his face? Apocalypse. Apocalypse. Superman can't even defeat Apocalypse. You know who defeats Apocalypse? Batman. Batman.
Wait, should I put a spoiler there? I don't care, but
because he's the god.
Should I say like
Batman.
A spoiler there?
It's not
if anyone cares.
It's not much. It's an old comic. To be
okay, so I wouldn't know that.
You know why he beats him? He's the goddamn Batman. Sheesh.
No, actually, that's the only time Batman ever uses a gun. Batman has this thing where he doesn't use a gun, and then. It's hilarious because Apocalypse is like this, he's this ruler of an entire planet called Apocalypse. Mm-hmm. It's like this whole dystopian planet with lava and everything, mm-hmm. and like everyone dies, nihilism, and he's super awesome. He fires beams from his eyes that follow you and are faster than the speed of light. And Superman can't dodge it, but Batman can. By running away, yeah. Just putting it out there. Batman is OP in every regard.
Yeah.
And Batman never uses
And he has
gun.
No freaking superpowers.
Right. Apocalypse defeats Superman, and then Batman, with no superpowers, goes up to Apocalypse with a gun, shoots him, and Apocalypse dies.
Wow.
Anyways,
back to what the hell were we talking about? Amazing Spider-Man 1?
We were talking about Dark Knight. Dark Knight was terrible because it didn't
No. Are you talking about Dark Knight Rises? Right?
I didn't like any of the movies.
Oh, okay. What? Then I disagree. I am not there.
I like
Unpopular it. Opinion alert.
I really dislike the movies.
Oh my gosh.
While Heath Ledger was a really good Joker, they just didn't portray Batman very well.
Did you just call him Heath Ledger?
He's
okay,
up
good.
Goodness.
You said it right. Okay, good.
Yeah, I know I said it right. Thank you. While Heath Ledger was an amazing actor as the Joker,
can I not throw this?
Batman was. Who was the actor for Batman?
Christopher Nolan.
Christopher Nolan sucked as Batman. Oh, Christian Bale!
Christian Bale!
Christian Bale! Wait, who's Christopher Nolan?
Good job, man. Good job.
Dude, I'm playing games, okay? It's hard to concentrate.
Wait, who's Christopher Nolan?
No, Christopher Nolan is the director.
Yeah, Christopher Nolan is the director.
You see, it's hard. It's a good, like, a reasonable mishap.
Christian Bale
was a good, was a decent Batman. Christopher Nolan was terrible at directing the movie.
Yeah.
Here's why. Batman isn't just muscle. Batman's a genius. Batman's a super genius, smarter than Iron Man. Batman is awesome.
So and it's kind of your same argument for Amazing Spider-Man, the first one.
No, but even more so, because they made Batman this, like, all he does is use gadgets and, like, beat people up with his muscles. That's not Batman.
Yeah, true.
Batman is, like, he's got multiple degrees in multiple fields, and they failed to portray his genius properly.
He's not tactical enough in the movie.
Yeah, they failed to portray his genius properly in the movies.
I guess.
And I felt that was really, they were trying to appeal to, like, I know, people who don't care about Batman as anything other than some muscly guy.
Oh, then that's me, then. Joking. Well, yeah, like I said before, I'm not really comic-wise familiar with Batman, so I like the movies. I have no really nostalgia attached, so I didn't really care what they exactly did with him. Granted, I still hated Rises. Well, I didn't hate it, but I thought it was overrated.
But, I know. Also, I found they did the same thing with Bane. Mm-hmm. Bane is also not... Like, Bane is super muscly, but the reason that Bane is Batman's ultimate foe... Like, there's a lot of villains that are much stronger than Bane. But the reason Bane wins is because Bane is a super genius as well. Mm. Like, Bane knows multiple languages. Bane is a genius in multiple fields. And they failed to portray that as well. Like, they portrayed him as some jock guy who runs around and hits people.
Mm. And breaks Batman's bat.
And breaks Batman.
Okay. Well,
breaks the bat.
While we like to talk about Batman more, this is not exactly...
Should I give my opinion about Batman?
Fine, do it really quickly.
Okay, so... I don't disagree with Yaya, but I believe that The Dark Knight was an amazing movie.
Yes,
like,
I agree.
The plot, the script, the writing, the Joker. I mean, that was possibly the most epic portrayal of a chaotic mastermind, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It was amazing.
Look, everybody. It's working! you realize, if you guys look back at, I know, shameless plug-in, but if you guys look at our LPs, me and Anna say a lot of things at the same time.
Anna and I,
sorry for any grammar Nazis out there. We say a lot of things at the same time. It's not even funny, like, go check it out.
I'm passing it to Blow.
Oh! I had one life, but then what up? Yeah! No! Oh! Too small for you.
That's what she said.
Sorry, I couldn't resist.
Oh my god.
As you nice. Wow.
And he's like,
yeah, I'm a ballerina.
No, I can't do it anymore.
Spider-Man's and no, it's right there.
I did a little bit. Anyways,
his costume because
yeah, I know, man. Half, I'm getting started to be half naked. yeah, like Miley Cyrus, pretty much. But yeah.
Anyway, we just have this psychic link.
Yes.
Between us.
But can we stop talking about Batman? Unless you have anything to add below.
No, I just wanted to say, man.
Any clothing statements?
Batman. The Dark Knight Rises, I mean, it was, I didn't like how Batman was defeated. I mean, he got stabbed by a knife. His armor can stop bullets, and he got stabbed by a knife.
Actually, Kevlar armor that stops bullets, being a non-Newtonian fluid, works because high impact makes it clunch up together. So it's like a liquid when it's not in high
speed. But still! No, can you not dodge a knife? It's a knife!
No, this is science.
Nerd explanation.
So it's in high impact, the Kevlar would bunch up together and become solid and really powerful. But then when it's all loose, and in low impact, it's like a liquid.
Okay, so nerd!
A knife is too slow. A knife is too slow to trigger the Kevlar's protective abilities.
Okay. I just want to put just a little disclaimer here. I had no clue that this video was going to be like this unrelated, so I apologize, but hey, at least we get perspectives on a lot of things other than this experiment.
All of like the superhero movies.
Well, and Star Wars. But no better other day to do it, you know?
This is like the biggest nerd video that yes. you'll ever watch.
Pretty much. And probably the most unpopular opinions on the internet you'll ever hear.
Yes.
So yeah.
Okay, back to Spider-Man!
No, I want to hear this boring explanation. What?
Kevlar can't stop knives because knives move too slowly to trigger the Kevlar.
Mm-hmm. But still, he's the goddamn Batman!
It was point blank! How is he gonna dodge that?
I don't know!
Oh, he's
the goddamn Batman!
Nerd rage!
Improvise!
The only argument you can make in that situation is he should have had a bat healer bat spray bat heals him.
Bat heals.
Really bat quickly.
The bat heal.
Like how Spider-Man did in the.
If anyone.
Maybe that's like a.
Yeah.
If anyone is a fan of the original, and I don't think anyone is, the original Batman with.
Which one? Jack Nicholson?
No, the original. Original. Like,
that much older than that.
Who was it? Like, the really original ones. Like, the TV shows that
in the 80s?
The TV shows? Adam West!
Adam West, thank you!
Batman! What's up with the freaking 60s shows having memorable themes? Spider-Man, too!
Right. If anyone's a fan of the original Adam West Batman, and I only watch them because they're hilarious.
They're freaking hilarious. It's the funniest thing. They're funnier than YouTube poops. So
in the movie that they made, it's like, going back to the whole bat thing, the bat shark repellent.
What about the bat credit card in freaking, Batman Returns, was it?
The bat everything.
The bat toilet paper. Oh my gosh.
Oh, man. Adam West, though. Adam West was hilarious.
Anyways, are we done talking about Batman?
Please.
I guess the only thing left to say is that I didn't hate Rises before anyone like comments saying Rises was a great movie. I like if it didn't come back from Dark Knight, then of course I would have liked it more because my expectations wouldn't have been so high. But after all the praise, like I remember Bilal, he was freaking tweeting all about it, like saying this is like the freaking best movie ever. Even at the time, you did say it was better than The Dark Knight, so I was like, oh yeah, my expectations are so high now. But you know. So I was a bit disappointed, but it's a good movie. It's just it's overrated. Anyways, back to the first Amazing Spider-Man. What were your thoughts about them rebooting the series?
Terrible.
I was disappointed too because I still wanted to see.
I didn't expect that much.
So
for
I had two faces. I had two phases. Well, three technically. Mm-hmm. So the first one was they're rebooting the series, and I was like, oh no, they're rebooting the series.
Okay. Yeah.
And I was like, I got sad.
Yeah, everyone was sad. Then that's natural, right. By the way.
Then my second phase was, I'm going to give this a chance.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah. And then my third phase was, this movie's terrible.
Yes, I don't think it was terrible, but I thought it was really forgettable. Andrew Garfield, I feel, I see this all the time in, you know, comment sections, but I have to agree, when it comes to playing Peter Parker, not Spider-Man, like in this costume right now, I think Tobey Maguire got the job done better.
Yeah.
Because I believe he was a socially awkward guy. Yeah. You know, he really looks like a freaking nerd. And he acts like one too.
Yes.
When it comes to being Spider-Man, cracking jokes and just like, you know, moving around. And you know, that might be due to like directing and stuff like that, of course, as well. But I thought he was a lot more funnier. He cracked a lot more jokes. Like, I remember the carjacking scene as well. That was pretty funny. You know what I'm talking about, right? I know it was a forgettable movie, that was a little bit more of the iconic sections.
Yeah.
Okay. In my opinion, Tobey Maguire did a much better job as Peter Parker, and Andrew
Garfield did a better job as Spider-Man.
Right.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah. Tobey Maguire couldn't nail the badassness of Spider-Man.
Yes, exactly.
And Andrew Garfield couldn't nail the emotional spectrum of Peter Parker.
Exactly, right? Because I believe...
Okay, never
mind. Yeah, Anna, continue. Sorry, I was gonna.
No, it's fine. You can go.
But yeah, like when it comes to emotion, I know Anna like made the statement about how he's whiny Tobey Maguire's character was whiny and he cries a lot. Yes, he's supposed to be emotional. People, you know.
Yeah, but not that emotional.
No,
yeah.
He is. He is that emotional.
Yes. Like, when Uncle Ben died, I actually did cry the first time. Granted, yes, I was very, very young, but I still feel them feels every time I watch. Yes. Wait, oh, I like. Can I just say I hate the way Uncle Ben died in The Amazing Spider-Man?
Oh, no, it was terrible.
Yeah.
Let me explain the plot.
Okay. Calm your spider senses.
So Peter Parker storms out of his house because he has teenage hormone issues things, and then.
What the hell are you talking about?
So he storms out of the house. Ben Parker follows him onto the street. He's buying some milk.
Why milk, man? Why can't he buy like Red Bull or something?
He sees there's this guy behind him with who seems already shady and he has long hair and he has this weird sort of
tattoo. Yeah.
And shut up!
My horse is amazing. Give it a lick. It tastes like just raisins. Okay, I know you're done now.
Okay.
So basically, he died because
he went out to get Peter Parker.
Yeah. And
it was
kind of lamer though the way
it was
he died.
It was immensely lame. He died for milk.
It's the same thing.
No, it wasn't. It was a bit different. It wasn't exactly the same. It wasn't by a carjacker.
It totally wasn't the same.
Yeah.
I have a question. Why didn't Spider-Man just string him up onto the roof with like webs and stuff?
I mean, right now, those are pretty strong. This right now?
Vermin. This fight could have ended like 10 minutes ago.
Yeah. Well, Spider Slayer. I wonder if they're gonna bring that in any of the new series. But anyways, yes.
Spider Slayer?
Yeah. But like I said before, to go back on the cast of new characters, I like Emma Stone as Gwen Stacy way better than Kristen Dunst. Both character wise and just acting wise.
How did you teleport from Spider-Man?
This is not Emma Stone. This is wannabe Emma Stone. Yeah. Oh my gosh, freaking deformed Emma Stone. That's where it belongs, right? No.
She has no eyeballs.
Oh, wait, quick.
She has no, you know what?
Quick question.
She's not even looking at you.
Yeah, I know. She's just like left and right. I like your apartment.
Okay, how did you teleport from Spider Slayer to your apartment? Just quick question.
No, because I'm replaying missions.
Oh.
It'd be back when like you do story mode, you like go to straight to the next one.
Okay,
let's change the costume.
Costume. Go with the green one.
Ooh, that's big time. I forgot which series. No, it kind of looks weird.
What's the black and white one?
This one is when he's the Fantastic Four member Johnny Storm dies. Yeah, it's weird. That's going really deep into the scene.
Okay, how about the gray and black one?
Gray and black. This one?
Yeah.
Negative Zone. That's when he has to see in the dark or something, I believe. I forgot which villain it was.
Uh-huh.
Not a true fan, I know.
Dark
I forgot the name.
Okay, so what
this
about...
is the black suit.
Yeah,
this is actually from the movies,
according to.
And this is the one from the comics. That one looks pretty cool, actually.
Yeah, it does.
Well, it's not exactly like the comics,
but. I just want to buy these costumes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well,
what about the
Scarlet Spider? This is when
I know Scarlet Spider.
Anyways, while we're going, which costume should I pick, by the way, for the
Scarlet Spider.
Big boy.
Scarlet Spider. Okay.
Oh, I want big boy.
Oh, look at this cross pieces.
Wait,
this
what?
Is.
Pick that one.
Oh God! Yes, please.
Pick that one.
Okay, fine. Hey, Gwen.
You love me now.
Hey, he saved all of us.
I think she made it blind, actually.
Yes.
Oh God.
Oh God.
Oh God.
Okay, so like I was saying, yes, Emma Stone's better as the female lead.
Yeah. Yeah. Then.
Kristen Dunst as Mary Jane. Both.
Yes. Shit.
Yeah, and she always got.
No, yeah,
like,
she's terrible.
She also cheated. She also cheated on like every single like you know love interest that she had throughout all the three movies.
Mm.
If you really pay attention,
it was Harry in the first movie,
yeah.
And then it was J. Jonah's son in the second one, the astronaut, which by the way turns into a villain in the comic books, the werewolf.
Yes.
I don't know if they're ever gonna get into that. Who knows? Probably not, because they haven't even brought Jonah yet.
Let's hope they don't.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. But anyway,
I didn't like the werewolf.
Well, because of Twilight too, you know, that kind of like gets our expectations.
No,
Edward's
exactly.
Probably gonna.
I really don't think they would nail his character down.
Yeah, well, yeah, and there's so many other villains to choose from before you go there.
Yeah.
He's definitely one of the lesser known ones.
Oh, so that's the Scarlet Spider.
Wait, so how did he get here?
Yeah.
It was like...
Yeah.
Times Square.
Oh,
wow. Hideous. Secret. Oh, this happens in the secret scene at the end of the credits for Amazing Spider-Man 2, by the way.
What happens?
He turns into this.
No,
Andrew Garfield like peels off his mask. He's like, "Hey guys,
hey
Spider-Man."
Wait, what?
Ah, never mind.
Hey, dude.
Anyways,
were you paying attention?
No. Oh crap! He's about to like do his comic. Yeah, but anyways, I thought the first Amazing Spider-Man was forgettable. I liked the high school fight scene. I remember liking that one a lot.
Yeah.
It reminded me a lot of the cartoons, like Spectacular Spider-Man. It did better than freaking Ultimate Spider-Man, that's for sure.
Yeah.
But that's a rant for another time, the TV shows. which I love most, for the most part, except for freaking, you know, Ultimate. And the 60s series goes without saying. Even though it was freaking amazing because it created the memes we know and
love
today. Yeah, any other thoughts about the first Amazing Spider-Man?
It was terrible.
It was alright.
Yeah,
I'm not gonna say it's terrible.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it was alright.
Yeah.
It wasn't.
Lizard was a terrible.
Completely amazing.
Lizard
like,
was a terrible
piece of
character
art,
choice.
But
okay.
For the first villain, maybe yes,
for
I agree.
The first,
yeah. Maybe you can start up his character arc in that movie. That would have been cool.
Yeah.
But not exactly for like a villain for the whole thing, kind of.
Okay, so Lizard,
maybe if he was a minor character, third movie or something, that would be not right.
Piss at them, piss. Okay.
Mm.
Lizard was a terrible character choice. Tobey Maguire. No, sorry. Andrew Garfield.
Yeah.
Andrew Garfield does a good Spider-Man, but they spent most of the movie as Peter Parker.
Yes, and they freaking spent 1 hour to get him to Spider-Man. That was...
Another terrible choice.
Such a drag.
Another terrible choice. And, It all seemed extremely scripted. Like, they're like, "Oh, I need to get to the building," and all the cranes move to get in his path.
Oh, yeah.
"Dead Spidey, you're awesome."
Yeah. Generally, in the comics and just in series in general, most of the people are against Spider-Man.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what he struggles through.
Yeah.
Like, in his
beginning. Yeah, that's why...
The people liked him too fast and too early.
Yeah. And in the second movie, that is kind of a little bit, like, very relevant, too. Not very many people hate him, except for, like, you know, Jonah.
By the second movie, this is not really a spoiler, but everyone loves him.
Yeah. He has a lot of fanboys.
Everyone just loves him.
By the time he fights Electro.
Yeah. Exactly, right?
Yeah.
You'll see. It's so obvious. There's definitely one scene
Well, we'll explain this further when we get to the spoiler part of this.
Hey, we're getting to Amazing Spider-Man 2, I swear. We're going to get to that very good.
We're
going
to get to it.
Anyways, the whole...
Does it sound like an annotation in the...
At the beginning, you can just click it, skip the 1 hour to where I thought about like our Amazing Spider-Man 2.
And
here's some other links to like us talking about Batman, Star Wars. Oh, wow. It's done already? Oh, no, oh yeah, this is when it splits. I love this boss fight. It splits into multiple spider slayers.
Yeah.
Anywho.
Wait, what about that big guy?
That's
in the beginning, right?
Yeah, and now he split.
I'm almost done the game, so I don't remember this stuff.
So, are we done talking about the Amazing Spider-Man?
I just got, what'd you think about the CGI animation?
It wasn't the worst, and I'm not going to make any quips about it because it wasn't bad.
Oh, crap. That's gotta hurt in the
moment. Well, that was actually out of the laws of physics. I mean, he didn't move at all.
Yeah. He's just like, I can move in minute. Well, I defy physics.
I'm free.
Falling. Okay. Anyways,
Falling.
You guys are so bad at this.
What, singing or talking about our views on stuff?
Singing. Amazing Spider-Man 1 was terrible. I think that's consensus except for Belong.
No, I don't think it was terrible, but it was forgettable. Like, for ironically, though, I find Spider-Man 3 more memorable than Amazing Spider-Man 1. Granted, it was for a lot of the bad points, but,
Maybe because the third one was... It came out a lot.
Yeah, but I like the... Dang it, man. Keep King Kong this freaking...
That was much more physics.
Yeah, that was much more physics.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
And sorry for dying. As I said before, it's hard to get my opinions.
How about you give the remote to me?
And then are you sure you can talk about something?
Yes, I can do this.
All right, and it's gang playing now, so, you know. Expect pro. Okay.
I don't play console.
I don't play console. Okay, anyways, back to whatever we were talking about. So,
okay, so R1 to...
Adnan, no. If you're going to ask about how to play the game, yeah. You're not going to play the
hey,
game.
Hey, I play console, right? Not... I don't know the controls. Oh. What? Okay. No. I shall beat this.
Okay, so Amazing Spider-Man 1 was... It had some really bad points, and it had some good points.
Yeah,
the good point most... was Gwen Stacy.
Yes, and, okay, I like Spider-Man's humor, the action scenes, for the most part. I hated some things I hated was the fact that it took forever for Spider-Man to be Peter Parker.
Okay,
and
now
Yaya's playing. And
what's the funniest?
It was probably the cop carjacker scene.
The knife.
Yeah.
Oh, not even.
But what my favorite scene was probably the high school fight because we never really saw a high school fight in the original trilogy.
Yeah, really. It was so just... Flash Thompson.
Yeah. You kind of
did.
Oh, yeah. Flash Thompson, yes.
Yeah.
Like, I meant in his suit, you know? Because he has to fight, like, in between his high school schedule and shit. But yeah, I thought it was forgettable. I didn't hate it. I thought it was, at most, good. Hard for me to say good. More okay. I don't give 10 rank. I don't give, like, the freaking, like, score rankings. Because at the end of the day, you want to know if you want to see it or not. Just for the sake of me loving or liking Amazing Spider-Man 2, I say you have to see it just to get caught up with the events.
Yeah. Can I say my opinion?
Yes, yeah, sure.
Okay, so in my opinion, The Amazing Spider-Man 1 was an alright movie. It wasn't a complete waste of time, like Yaya is saying. And I kind of agree with Brandon. Here, I mean, it was all right.
It was all right. That's the best word.
It wasn't great, and it wasn't like completely amazing, mind-bogglingly awesome. But it was okay. It was a good, time, like a good flick.
It's a good one-nighter.
It's a good flick.
I guess unless anyone else has anything to add. Oh, and I gotta say, Aunt May's performance wasn't bad. It actually is good, but it doesn't beat the original Aunt May, in my opinion.
Yes, the original Aunt May.
Yeah. The original Aunt May was amazing.
Yeah. Especially your monologue in the second movie, I didn't mention that already.
The original Uncle Ben passed away.
Yeah, I know. Just for those who didn't know, the original Uncle Ben died in 2009, I believe.
Before the first one.
Before the first one came out, shortly 2 years after the third movie. And I thought Uncle Ben did a great job as well. Both Uncle Bens, yeah. I didn't hate the Amazing Spider-Man Uncle Ben. He did okay.
So I guess after...
But I hated how he said... Did he even say, with great power comes great responsibility? Didn't he twist the words around a bit? I know they didn't want to make it seem like they're doing the same thing, but you can't change that.
Yes. It's what Spider-Man is.
Yeah, it's all about.
It's what Spider-Man is, you know? It's what he follows for the rest of his flipping life.
Yeah.
Those words.
Yeah.
And you can't change those words.
Yeah. Great freaking power comes great responsibility to kick ass.
You forgot to say freaking, but okay.
You said
freaking the first time.
No, you said forgot to... I was supposed to add freaking to it?
Yes. You're supposed to say great freaking power comes great freaking responsibility.
Don't worry, water does not kill you. Back in most Spider-Man games, you can actually swim in it, but in this one, you can't. Yeah, okay, can we finally talk about the movie we saw 2 days ago in theaters?
With spoilers.
Can I give it another shot, actually?
With full spoilers.
Yeah, no, we'll talk, okay, just without the spoilers.
How?
We'll just say our, like, overall thoughts.
Well, I did much better than Adnan.
Yeah, even if you couldn't tell already, I loved it way better than the first one. To the point where I'd say go see it now.
Yes.
If you haven't, unless you haven't seen the first one.
Stop watching this video, pause it, go
see
it.
No, go watch, see this rest of this 2 hour long video and then go watch it. If it isn't like midnight already. But yeah, I liked it much better than the first one. Let's start with, I guess, the
story. We did not get paid by Sony to do this.
No, yes, I know.
Wait, Sony?
Sony does the movies.
Oh, yeah. Really? Oh, I didn't know. So
wow, not true fan right there.
Yeah, don't even know the facts, boy.
I'm just gonna go ahead and say, it was really really good, and the two movies you have to see are Captain America and Spider-Man.
Oh yeah, but Okay, I'll say this much. And this might piss off lots of people.
I have not watched Captain America. Don't say anything.
Shut up. We're not gonna do any spoilers except for Hail Hydra. Captain America 2 is the better movie, I'm not gonna lie. If you haven't even... Go see that one first, if you haven't.
Yeah, I agree.
And I can't freaking concentrate.
Okay, that below play.
Bilal? Actually, yeah, Bilal. Yeah, you do the least talking Bilal anyways. Play.
There's a lack of Bilal's
playing now.
There's a giant lack of Hydra in Spider-Man.
Yes.
That's all I'm gonna say.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Now spoilers.
See, for anyone who reads the comics, that's like a huge spoiler.
Yeah.
Don't worry, it's not actually a spoiler.
Okay, maybe somewhat spoilers for Captain America, okay?
It doesn't really it doesn't even
somewhat spoilers,
it's
okay?
Not, okay, us saying Hydra isn't going to spoil
the movie. I know.
Because Hydra doesn't...
We all know that Hydra is Captain America.
No.
Hydra is like...
No, but even if you didn't...
Yeah.
Hydra in Captain America movies is not like Hydra in the comics. Mm. Not at all.
Yeah.
Not one bit. Just putting it out there.
Yeah, but... Okay, but we can talk about that, why that is, and how that's a good thing, but this is...
That a good thing.
Well, what? No, really. You told me on the bus the other day you found it was okay. It wasn't like an Iron Man 3 twist.
Pretty good.
Oh no. What I
What
I meant to say was okay.
What
about Hydra was good. Shield was terrible.
Ah.
Yeah. And because Hydra and Shield were.
Bilal is the only one that actually took one of them down.
Well, I took one of them down. So. Yeah.
Okay, go on.
Anyways, yes. But then again, Bilal's not talking.
Yeah.
No, no. Keep playing the game, Bilal. We can talk. You lose everything.
Okay.
Yeah, we're just taking turns. Dan ends back on the controller. Don't expect much.
Back
what did his text say?
Spider-Man.
Yeah, two. Okay, without any spoilers, what was it? What's
Captain
your
America
thought?
2 was really good.
Yes. Yeah. Barely. Yeah.
Spider-Man 2 was also really, really good. They portrayed his. They played off what Andrew Garfield did really well in the first one,
mm-hmm.
and they emphasized that, so it ended up being really good.
Yeah, and if even it is possible. They made him even funnier. Like all of his quips as Spider-Man. I don't remember one line I didn't laugh, except for maybe Sparky.
Sparkle.
That was the only one lame one. I was hoping for electricity puns.
There was a huge lack of puns.
Electricity puns. Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, there's a freaking stage in Shared that mentioned that after this boss fight, I should play because it relates to it somewhat.
The second one was really close to comics. Including costume and everything.
Yeah, what's your thoughts about the original Amazing Spider-Man costume?
No, one more try.
I like this one.
One more try.
I love the new costume better. What was your thoughts about the original costume change in the first movie? I didn't hate it. I just thought, okay, they're trying to spice it up a bit.
I liked it. Yeah. It looked hipper.
To be completely honest, the
wrestling ring experiment costume, yes.
I liked it a lot, and then I hated it a lot because I really liked the original one.
Yeah.
But then the newer one was also really nice.
Yeah.
Just like that nostalgia thing.
Yeah, the second one they brought back just to shut up the fans that complained about it.
Yeah. I liked it, I gotta say.
Yeah. So, and then they brought the newest costume in, more old school. And yeah, I like it better than the Amazing Spider-Man, so yeah. Anyways,
woo!
Nice job, Ant-Man, you actually did something. I forgot what... Yeah, I know, right? Everyone's taking now at least one Spider Slayer. But then again, it does get easier as they divide, like you take out one by one. Okay, so I guess we have to dive into the spoilers if we want to talk too much in the movie.
Yes, we do.
Except for the one last, thing before going any further. Please exit the video now because I do not want to hear you spoil the movie, blah, blah, blah.
Cue Dancing Spider-Man now!
Okay, back.
Okay, we're back.
Okay, spoilers. Gwen Stacy dies.
Gwen Stacy dies.
By the way,
my God.
Yeah, you're pretty much dead, I think.
I really liked Harry Osborn.
Oh. No.
Free phone.
Yeah.
Harry Osborn was really, really good.
Yes.
And while I didn't like...
I didn't like...
I didn't like how they rushed him to the evil side.
Right. I've got a couple of points there. I didn't like the whole disease thing, and I liked the whole disease thing.
Well,
because right when they showed Harry Osborn, Harry Osborn wasn't the kind of Harry Osborn that was, like, traditional.
He wasn't likable, you know what I'm saying? In the first two Spider-Man movies, the original series, you could connect with Harry Osborn.
Yeah. And why he hates Spider-Man. The reason why he hates Spider-Man is kind of really stupid. The most pointless scene in the movie, for those who saw it, you know what I'm talking about, is how, you know, Harry's dying and he needs Spider-Man's blood in order to survive.
And then he comes
in his freaking mansion. He's like, hey, Harry, I'd love to help you out, but I can't.
Okay. Yeah. Because it might kill you. Please. I know you're already dying.
He was watching him sleep.
Yeah, he was watching him sleep too, which is kind of creepy. That is the most pointless scene in the movie.
Also, how Harry reacts to that. Harry has come back after 10 years for 2 days, and he said, Spider-Man, or Peter Parker, you're like my best friend ever.
Yeah.
I know you for 2 days, but you're still my best friend.
Yeah.
Why are you letting me die? I'm like, dude, I don't know you.
Well, no, he does know him because he does have a childhood experience.
I know,
but
like,
it's hard to believe
10
that.
Years. Yeah. 10 years is a long time.
Yeah.
It's a decade.
That's why they had that freaking like beach scene and carnival to have that like bromance. I wanted to see more bromance, and maybe if they wanted to pull like an original Spider-Man 2 at the end, they could hint, oh, he's Spider-Man and he let me down and I'm about to die. Let me get my father's stuff. But I guess they didn't want to be
I think his transformation to Green Goblin should have at least taken until the third movie. I don't know.
Maybe.
They should have given more time for Peter Parker and Harry Osborn's friendship to develop.
Yeah, I agree with that.
That's true. They just came in and he's like, we used to know each other and be best friends.
You could easily die. You messed up there.
And now let's talk about Emma Stone.
That's all I care about.
Emma Stone is hot.
Yes.
No. On a serious note, She was really
smart
in the movie, right?
Yes.
That's what I said before. She does more than getting like carried away by the enemy.
There is some depth to the heroine in this film.
Yes. That's what I was saying. It was funny. We were in the movies, right? And Yaya wasn't too familiar with the Gwen Stacy death plot.
No, I
was
not.
As soon as... I keep referring to Andrew, like their actors' names. I gotta stop doing that.
As soon as Green Goblin...
No. As soon as Peter and Gwen were like kissing and making out and saying they love each other on the bridge, I'm like, she's so going to die
dead.
At this point.
I knew
even though that she didn't die in the bridge.
Me and Brandon shared like a look or something.
Brandon
leaned to me and he's like, look, she's gonna die on the bridge.
Didn't I say something like Gwen Stacy's has a tendency to die on bridges or something?
And I'm like, okay, but they're not gonna do that in the movie.
And for a second when the free falling section when Spider-Man had that like web and had like a hand gesture they might save her just to like bring her back in the third.
I'm like, they're totally gonna save her and then she dies in the most brutal
in the same way in the comics.
Her head hits, and you can hear
the snap. We were watching it 3D IMAX, and it was like,
And everyone just went,
Yeah, like everyone was silent.
Everyone,
Ant-Man. And that's special for Ant-Man, because during every quiet moment in the freaking movie, Ant-Man points out something with his lame and pointless commentary. Like, remember, for example, in the beginning scene when Peter's parents are like in the plane, right? It's like, he's like, what? When there's like a blackout going into Spider-Man, he's like, why don't they have parachutes? And I remember someone behind me saying, shut the hell up, or something like that.
No, it was actually, I was pointing out that the parents were going to die.
For those who didn't watch the movie, she dies.
By now, hopefully.
If you haven't watched the movie now, leave.
Spider-Man? Spider-Man.
Maybe it's too late.
There's Brandon playing, by the way, now.
Yeah, I'm playing,
Spider-Man shoots a web to catch her. He catches her by the stomach, So she basically bends into her head,
yes,
hits the pavement, and her back cracks.
It's brutal.
It was the most brutal, brutal thing I could
imagine. And, like, of course, I don't like when I say this, I don't mean, like, yeah, Dyke went stacy, but I love it. Because it's kind of unexpected to the casuals, like Bilal.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Bilal, did you see it coming? Be honest.
No, yeah, because I saw...
You didn't see it coming.
No, because I heard...
You didn't see it coming.
Shut up. I know, because this, I knew that there were death rumors of her character.
What? How'd you know, sir?
On YouTube, dude, who said it?
Oh, people were spoiling on YouTube?
Yeah, I'm
freaking
no,
asshole.
No, like, news people, because Emma Stone said that on during the interview that.
Dang it!
That, this, she was.
Oh, that's
was,
weird. No,
the person was interviewing her, saying, it's her character gonna die, and she, I don't know, smiled or something, and that gave it away.
Yeah.
See, before I go watch a movie, I don't go on the internet.
Yeah.
That's my tradition.
Yeah, no, that is wise. Oh. And that same way works for video games, because there's lots of spoilers.
If anyone is looking for a comedy movie, Oculus. Oculus is a very comedic movie.
Okay, dude.
They say it's horror, but it's not.
Besides,
I laughed.
Okay. No one cares right now.
That's the Amazing Spider-Man 2.
Yaya loves horror movies, by the way.
No, I don't. I hate horror movies.
No, he loves them for all the wrong reasons.
Yeah.
You're going to die now.
Yes.
I find most horror movies...
I did die. Oh!
Pro Les is going to die in 5 seconds.
Where's the web striker?
Just press one in front, R1. One behind. You don't need to... Okay.
I said the R1 striker.
So,
guys, dang it.
They spent a 20 million dollars. I think they already
passed. Amazing Spider-Man 2. Electro was.
Nice.
Okay.
Electro is pretty cool.
Electro is cool. I have nothing to say about how he transitions.
I like Electro's, I guess, character buildup.
Yes.
Of what he was. They didn't just say, hey, okay. Here's the villain.
Yeah.
You know? You actually felt sorry for him. Yeah. That this guy was a complete nobody and, like, you know, Spider-Man, like, you know, noticed him. And then he got obsessed. And then he was like...
It's like a drug addiction.
Yeah, exactly. He got obsessed with Spider-Man.
No, he also got obsessed with his self-image, which was kind of like an asshole-ish kind of thing. But during the New York fight scene, he was like, Spider-Man's got the screen time and not me.
He also had... he also Gollum'd a little, too.
Gollum? What do you mean Gollum?
Gollum?
Gollum.
Electro.
You know how he talked to himself.
Electro!
But that's his personality as well.
Yeah. I like how he did that.
They did a really good job portraying him as a schizophrenic.
Yes.
Yeah.
Or a semi-schizophrenic. Mm. They did a really good job portraying him as delusional.
Yeah.
Yes.
I think I finally finished this, by the
way.
I don't know if you guys watched this, Spider-Man the Animated Series. I'm referring to the 2003 series where it had, like, that dark storyline.
The Animated Series.
it had, like, two episodes. It was very short. It only lasted one season with, like, 14 or 15 episodes. But one of those villain scenarios was Electro, and it really reminded me of those episodes because it made you... both characters design-wise and plot-wise, it made you feel sorry for the character.
The character design the character design was very good.
It also looked like freaking Dylan from The Infamous.
Also, the visuals in this movie
first,
are awesome.
The character design was very good. So the way he transforms is he falls into a vat of eels. Is that like the comics?
I forgot about the Ultimate series, but in the original, no.
Okay, so in the original comics, that's... I really liked it because what ends up happening is he falls into a vat of eels, and when he transforms, he himself ends up looking like an eel and acting eel-like. It ends up really...
He even has sharp teeth.
Ends up being really, really good.
Just a quick thing. The reason why I'm changing from Black Spider-Man is because I'm going to show off the Shattered
Dimensions.
And then I'm going to show the Shattered Dimensions level after one more thing. So let's do Future Foundation. Okay, continue, sorry.
The Atmos that you got...
Atmos, nice.
The Atmos that you got from being around Electro was just really good. His voice, whenever he talked, just like that vibration.
Yeah.
That electrifying vibration was really, really good.
Yeah, and I love that, like, dubstep. Like, at first I thought it was really cheesy, the dubstep. Yeah, every time he moved, they were like, dun, dun, dun.
Whatever.
Everything needs dubstep. Spider-Man referenced it. Yeah. I hate this song.
Yeah, at the very end. That was funny, yeah.
I hate this song.
You see, that's how you freaking break the fourth wall. Not like an Ultimate Spider-Man, where every time you say a lame joke, you go to the audience and like, oh, that was pretty lame. But, you know, jokes and stuff.
I hate Ultimate Spider-Man.
Yes, we'll get onto that. Maybe we'll save some time at the end of this video. But yes, continue.
I really like that as well, because it really added to his delusional thing.
Yeah, and like the voices in his head as well during the New York Times Square.
The song literally went, I trusted Spider-Man, then Spider-Man, I loved Spider-Man, and then he betrayed me and now he's my enemy or something like that.
Yeah, and when you play the, if you played it backwards, it probably said, I love Satan. It's probably true. Someone, like, when someone gets a DVD, like, play backwards, like, I love Satan.
It added to the
Phantom Menace, like, yeah.
Phantom Menace is awesome. I loved what's her face? Amidala.
Paul Abdul? No.
What?
Yeah, what?
Amidala.
Yeah, Paul Abdul. Isn't that her actor, though? Right? Paul Abdul. No, yes. For Queen Amidala.
Can't remember.
Either
way, I hated Amidala. Amidala is terrible.
Yeah. Sorry for not playing, by the way, guys. This is the last mission.
So, it added to the whole... he's delusional and he's schizophrenic thing. Added to the whole he's delusional and schizophrenic thing, because it made him basically...
Early missions.
He'd go anywhere, he'd have voices in his head. So,
yeah.
The atmosphere that you got... Anywhere around Electro was really, really good.
Yeah, if I could add anything to make references to the old movies, it was kind of like Doc Ock in two scenes. One was when the hospital scene, when he wakes up. Granted, they didn't do anything extreme like killing people, which I kind of wish they... it was really terrifying in the second movie how he was like killing all the nurses. But in The Amazing Spider-Man, they didn't like exactly do that, but the way he waked up, it really reminded me of that. Whoa. But also, the voices in his head was kind of like the tentacles. And Felicia was also in the movie. I forgot to add as soon as
since we were seeing. Oh yeah, Felicia was in the movie.
Yes, as Peter's
Harry's
assistant, which is probably gonna tie into something in the third movie.
Please no, she was terrible.
She wasn't exactly terrible. She barely had any like.
Oh,
screen time.
Black Cat.
Yes, Black Cat.
No, she was terrible. She's gonna make a terrible Black Cat.
Haven't even seen her as like.
She doesn't look like a Black Cat.
Well, that's because she doesn't have the freaking wig like this.
Okay, fine.
That's Emma Stone, not... She's
probably going to get a white wig or something.
Yeah.
No, that's not what... She just doesn't... Okay, fine. If she turns 180, then it'll be a little
bit better. But, yeah, so they're obviously going to tie something. Oh, look at this. This is pretty funny. Chandelier.
So what was I saying? The atmosphere around Electro was really good.
Yes.
Harry Osborn was an amazing Green Goblin and an amazing Harry Osborn as well.
Mm-hmm.
Norman Osborn was not even like, you know, he wasn't...
To be completely honest, I liked how Norman Osborn wasn't in the movie.
Yes.
He was very briefly anyway.
He was very briefly. Just
because you can't replace the original Goblin.
He was basically like... the disapproving father, you know,
Peter, you suck ass! I'm a guy now, you better do better than me!
Yeah.
And son, I am disappointed!
Son, I am disappointed!
I like how they didn't try to replace Norman Osborn.
Because Willem Dafoe is just too awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a new movie, so they're trying a new thing by having Green Goblin be Harry Osborn.
Yeah, yeah.
And
from the get-go, anyways, yeah.
And
Green Goblin's character design really nice, but the build-up was really good at times. I will get to the parts where it's really bad. Mm-hmm. It was really good at times, like when he's extremely creepy. Like he literally pops up behind Gwen.
Wait. Before we talk about that, to quote, like in the theaters, every time there was like a jump scare, Yayo would freaking like back onto me. Well, I could feel him shake, so loss of your manhood there. Like, I was more scared by Yaya, like, backing up. I'm like, what the heck is happening here?
I get scared at jump scares. I don't get scared in horror movies.
Oh, sorry, like, I keep stopping.
Okay, elevator scene. That part, that little comedic thing with the coffee.
He basically showed up. Yeah.
It was hilarious.
He showed up behind her, and he's like, Peter's awesome.
Yeah.
Tell him to give me his blood.
Elevator scenes are always funny in the Spider-Man movies. Remember in the second one, too? When the guy's like, nice Spider-Man suit. Anyways, and there's also that Spider-Man, also another scene with Electro.
Thing.
Where he's like, where he's trying to, like, get the hots on Gwen Stacy. Remember Electro?
Yeah.
He's like, oh, chick. It's like, I have celebrities.
The elevator scenes were really good.
Yeah. Highlights, no, I'm joking. They weren't exactly like the biggest highlights, but they're funny.
They were the highlights.
They were very funny. Yeah. Especially the Electro elevator scene.
Yeah.
I'm having a party later.
Wait, remember my name.
You know, Miley Cyrus is going to be there, you know.
Oh, I'd like to make a point. I did not like how Spider-Man told Gwen that he's Spider-Man.
Yeah, it was kind of too soon, but... Yeah,
he should have done it
but
much
how
later.
How he did it was nice.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, the thing about Spider-Man is that you want him to tell him, like, his identity because he wants to, like, you know, impress people.
Yeah, but
there's also some responsibility in that. Granted, it has to happen eventually, but maybe not in the first movie. Yeah.
You know, I'm Spider-Man.
Oh, yeah. But what's done is done, and they did a really good job with it.
Oh, this is pretty funny looking. They had some... anyways, yeah, continue on, sorry.
So, yeah, they did a really good job with that. So, I liked it.
Yeah. And just since we're not talking about spoilers, Rhino is not in this movie as much as you would think. Oh, he's advertised so much in this movie, but
exactly.
Rhino is in the movie, yes.
And even then, he kind of sucks. And then Rhino after
Rhino's
Rhino...
Rhino's like... No, yeah. I think Rhino was only there so they could end the movie in a cool way.
Yeah, and it was in a cool way.
In a cool way, yes, but that was basically the entire purpose of Rhino.
Yeah, exactly. And also maybe to tease the Sinister Six movie.
I went into the movie saying it was going to be terrible because Rhino is...
in it.
Because they've got too many villains.
But in the sense what that Rhino was in, like, the purpose he served, it wasn't bad in that way, because was what it was meant for.
It turned out being that they only had two villains, which was Green Goblin and Electro.
Yeah.
And they were both done really well.
Mm-hmm.
And then Rhino was just...
Yeah, in there.
Just in there.
Just for, like, because, hey, we have a Sinister Six movie.
Yeah.
By the way, what the... I searched this up just to clarify if there was any, like, crossover. What the heck was up with the ending credits sequence? You know, I looked it up, and apparently it has no reference to the series, Spider-Man series. It was just to promote past days.
I knew it.
That's all it was, just to see Jennifer Lawrence, you know, as Mystique. Granted, I'm looking forward to the movie, don't get me wrong, but all of us wanted to see, like,
Like, we stayed, and then I was sitting there after, and I'm like, there could be
another
one. It ends, and then the theater guys behind
me
are like...
Yeah, they're like, oh, yeah, we should have told you that there was no ending sequence. And they were waiting with us. They didn't just come out of nowhere.
Scumbag theater guys.
Yeah.
All I'm gonna say.
Good job there, guys. Thanks for wasting our time. Anyways, so that was really troll. So don't bother wasting unless you want to see like a little teaser of
X-Men. They're probably
X-Men
just gonna release it anyway as it's.
Then again,
trailer.
If you're watching this video and you haven't seen the second movie, you shouldn't be watching this video.
Well, that's the reason why we're talking about now is because they want to know our thoughts about the movie with the spoilers.
Yeah. The only reason you should be watching this video is that you've watched the movie already.
I don't know. The first.
Well, yeah, the first
video was.
This video is like 2 hours long.
Yeah.
So you should watch like the first
two
or like 1.5 hour.
Oh, there's what is it? Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., right? Not really.
Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.?
I think they're just cops.
No, that's just SWAT officers.
Yeah.
SWAT officer. All clear. SWAT officer.
You can see.
Okay, they don't notice Spider-Man.
Okay, we're not talking about the game though, guys. At least not now. Maybe one day we'll talk about
it. Maybe one day.
Anyways, so Jamie Foxx is Electro. You can really believe into his character.
Yeah, Jamie Foxx's Electro was very good.
Granted, while the New York Times Square scene was amazing, when I had to see it again to remember anyways all the things, but when you look, there wasn't too much fighting in that scene. It was more or less...
Shaving.
Yeah, well, that too. And I gotta say, the Spidey sense was awesome. Like the
My god, the emphasis on the Spidey sense is so good.
Okay.
So good.
The Spidey sense in that scene was amazing.
Yeah.
But that was the only scene that the Spidey... Like, literally...
Well, and the falling the Gwen Stacy
scene. He never uses his Spidey sense other than that.
Yeah.
It's just... I didn't like it.
Besides Gwen Stacy.
Like,
Spider-Man
has... basically, he... For those who haven't read the comics, and correct me if I'm wrong, when Spider-Man gets buffed, when his superpowers get buffed, he can start seeing the future, sort of.
Yes, very, very late into the comics, yes.
So, and then they never, like, Spider-Man's spider-sense lets him see the future, and they never even go on that.
Oh, well, that's too early, I'm not gonna lie, in my opinion, to go into that angle.
No, that's true. But I'm saying they should have played on the spiders.
Well, they did do that in the original trilogy too. Like I remember that high school scene in the original.
Right?
Yeah. Maybe like a little bit far ahead, I guess.
They should have had a bit more Spidey sense.
Yeah, I agree with you there. But I gotta say the fight scenes were spectacular. Okay,
just tip to the wise, take out the guy with the gun.
Yeah.
Do you know the final fight? It was actually really long, but they had to cut it out because if they kept it, it would be rated R movie.
Yeah.
Rated R?
Yeah. If they kept the
rated R.
Why would it be a rated R movie?
Why?
Because when Grant stage you guys, you will see Green Goblin laugh.
Cool. That actually would sound badass.
Why would that make it R?
Yeah, I know. Because the laughing is so...
And she doesn't die in the...
It was a sexual laugh.
If you buy the DVD,
you got turned on by...
You got turned on by the death.
Oh, damn. Harry Osborn, what the hell, man?
If you buy the Blu-ray, did you see that's not how she died.
Yeah.
I can't remember how she died. But they have to cut that scene out and do the scene.
But it's in Blu-ray.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm gonna buy it.
Stare my ass.
Okay.
I'm gonna have to watch it.
Like I gotta say, I'd like to buy that movie once it comes out.
Yes.
Amazing Spider-Man, the first one, though, not so much. It was just.
I bought all of them.
Yeah. I gotta say, while we're talking, all the swinging scenes with Spider-Man, while I'm playing a video game, it did feel exactly like a video game, which is a good thing.
Yeah.
Like, the perspective was amazing.
Yes.
Especially with
the same acrobatic moves.
Yeah.
The thing I had a problem with in the first trilogy was that, the swinging was, like, the webs went nowhere, and he would just swing, like, they went into the sky, and he would swing. And that was like, I was like, where are the webs going?
Yeah.
And this one, there's not so much that problem.
Yeah.
The webs actually go into the building.
Yeah.
So that was...
That's good. They fixed some mistakes.
I like that, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, and I love the final fight, of course. That was amazing. I can't see the whole... I might be alone on this one, but how do you guys feel about the action, like how much action there was? I feel that there wasn't actually too much. I thought the action was great. Let me just say, every action scene was great, but I felt that in the middle of the movie, there wasn't that much.
In my opinion, I think that there was a very nice combination of action and non-action, and that they didn't have that much action, but the action that they had was just
it was good. It was I craved for more.
Right. So they did a really good job with that. They didn't overplay it, so it ended up being really good. Yeah. I liked it.
There should be one more
fight. I felt that there should be like at least one more fight because the middle.
More Green Goblin.
We want more Carnage, people.
That's what we're saying. Carnage, they haven't introduced Venom and you gotta bring Carnage.
Carnage as in, like...
Granted, he's actually in the video game for this experiment, too.
If they put Carnage, and if they want a good portrayal of Carnage, the movie's gonna be rated R. That's all I'm gonna say.
But I want Carnage.
It's not gonna happen anytime soon.
I think there will be more Green Goblin.
Well, they're gonna make a Venom movie. They may make that rated R.
Maybe not. What I want them to do is make Spider-Man 3 a Venom and then Spider-Man 4 a Carnage.
No, they make Spider-Man
I
agree with you on that.
Or they could have Spider-Man 3 Carnage and Venom.
Mm-hmm.
No.
I don't think they're going to go into Venom at all, actually.
Yeah.
Or if they do,
they probably will.
Or if they
they will
be really late. But it's not
It's gonna be late, and that's a good thing in a way. What the? I'm getting.
Guess who's producing?
I cannot move.
Guess who's producing the third one?
Huh?
Andrew.
What?
He's producing it.
Andrew Garfield.
Yeah, he's producing it.
I don't believe.
Why are you on first name basis with Andrew Garfield?
Okay, fine. Abelal tries to find that
information.
Okay.
That might not be a good thing. Okay,
He might be producing, but he might just be like, it's a name on there.
Yeah, I know, right?
Yeah,
I'm just seeing whatever.
But remember that time he wanted to make Spider-Man gay?
Okay.
We're not going to get into this debate.
I love how we all said that once.
I know. In fact, all three of us, except for Bilal, did because he was too busy. But, no, that's really stupid, making Spider-Man gay. Can I just say that right now? If you want to make your own hero, go right ahead.
We're in the comics.
Yeah, of course. What I'm referring to when we're talking about gay and, all that stuff.
Oh, yeah, wait, they did announce the fourth movie.
They did announce the fourth movie, right? Anyways, but what I was saying is that earlier, like last year, it was like late last year, As a joke, I think, more or less. But in some way, I think he was...
Where am I going?
No, I don't think it was a joke. He was being completely serious, I think.
I don't think he was being completely serious.
Other way. You
and, yeah, and...
I was going the right way. This
No.
He wanted to make Mary Jane gay, apparently.
Yes. Or a woman. I mean, a man. Didn't he say that? Like, he wanted to explore his feelings, you know.
Feeling somewhere else.
Yeah, I know. Explore with another superhero. I'm okay if you do that with another superhero, but don't take a well-established hero like Spider-Man.
Yeah.
And, you know.
Where am I going?
Make MJ a dude.
But
the director thankfully spoke up on that and said, yeah. He could tell he did like that little laugh, like, no. You could go direct your own Spider-Man.
Where am I going?
And this is why Brandon plays. anyways, this is where you go, Anand.
Oh, okay.
Back to Anand playing again.
I really don't think that, even if he is a producer, I really don't think, and I really hope, that he doesn't make any decisions.
That's nice. Yeah.
So, he's a good actor. He's not a good director. Uh-huh. He's putting it out there.
He comes out in third one.
Yeah.
The movie was actually going to come out last year, right?
But Experiment 2?
But they shot half the movie.
No, go
realized
up!
That
oh my god.
Up the vent.
They realized that the actor who was playing MJ was in good.
I actually could believe that. But definitely they're going to put MJ or some sort of female interest, love interest in the third movie.
They have to.
Or they might put in Black Cat.
Mm-hmm.
That could be something.
It's actually
scenes. Because Felicia, they're right, Anand. They could do that.
Scenes of the original
Anand, what the heck are you doing?
I don't know.
Stuff, you know, in front of everyone.
Yeah.
Take out the guy on the balconies first.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
So, what were we talking about?
We're talking about the action ratio and stuff.
It was good.
Yeah.
I enjoyed it.
I thought they should have been there should have been like one more action scene. Because the middle was kind of a little bit long drawn. I know they have to do character development and, you know, talk about Peter's parents and stuff. Granted, I may be alone on this, but I didn't find the backstory of his parents exactly so interesting that, you know, you have to say so much in the trailers.
I like that they gave a little depth to Peter's character.
I liked that they wanted to do that, but it was kind of forgettable.
Yeah, me too. I agree. Like, it wasn't so interesting to the point where I cared. You know?
Oh, there
like, was Uncle Ben really talked about? Like, he was talked about very few times.
I wanted to care, but it didn't give me any.
Yeah, exactly, right? Like, you see his dad, he's essentially why Oscorp is filled with maniacs and, like, deadly creatures now. And that's probably going to lead into the future movies, like...
I see what they wanted to do with
where the whole is this
Peter Parker parents
yeah.
thing,
yeah.
but they just didn't pull it off to become
yeah.
like that. I see what they wanted to do.
Yeah.
They just didn't do it properly.
No,
yeah.
Okay, fine, whatever.
That was good. Yeah,
nice. That was totally.
And something completely off topic again, but remember that action scene when Electro has Spider-Man pinned down and he does a shoot the whoop with. I'm a fire laser. He doesn't say it, but I swear he has the mouth motion with electricity. Oh my gosh, people who watch the movie, you know what I'm talking about. It was hilarious. Like if I were ever to YouTube poop that, I would add that effect. Oh my gosh. Anyways, yes, there's not much in my
This is turning out to be an awesome hangout, guys.
But I don't think we have too much to talk about. Something funny about the Spider Kid. Did anyone see? I don't know if anyone's.
Everyone,
oh yeah, this
Wait! Shut up, Anand. Anyways, the Spider Kid. Right. Yeah. I was gonna say that. That was the freaking Spider
really,
Kid.
Really, really good.
Yes.
I love that.
On YouTube, that's Spider-Man, for those who don't even know what we're talking about. Just that connection. On YouTube, there's like the Spider-Man commercial for anyone who's partnered that would play before a YouTube video. And there was the mini Spider-Man, and there was a reflection, right?
You were dead.
I was like,
And you know who that mini Spider-Man was? It was the kid with the glasses in the movie.
Was it?
Well, probably not, but that's what my interpretation
of
it is now.
Because I saw it from a website that does... work in CGI.
Mm-hmm.
So no, it was CGI.
Yeah, I know. But what kind of funny, like, you know, speculation that could have been like the Spider Kid because he wore the costume at the end.
Oh,
I thought that was well done, by the way.
Something I did. Yeah, that was really
like it was
well
really
done.
A touching moment. Also, to go back to mentioning the original trilogy, they kind of had an Spider-Man 2 moment in the sense that Peter didn't want to be Spider-Man anymore.
Right.
And that was good. They made it short because you couldn't play back, do it again, or else it would be, okay, this is Spider-Man 2 all over again.
So, something I didn't like, though, was that Rhino just, like...
He stood there.
He just stood there.
Where
like,
is
oh,
he?
Let him have
his... They didn't have this emotional moment.
Let's not kill him with my huge guns and rockets and stuff.
Well, yeah, that's like a Cinema Sins kind of thing, though. Yeah. You know, it was for the sake of the movie,
right, of course.
You know, there's, like, other plot holes you can, like, poke fun at.
Yeah.
I like that ending. So it was a good way to end the movie.
Yes, it was
like with the Amazing Spider-Man 1. Granted, it was forgettable, but I was looking forward to the next movie. Same thing with the ending to this one. Like I'm stoked, and I'm disappointed that they didn't have like an extra credit sequence. Granted, they had all the villains, like they showed in the trailer. They showed like the Vulture's wings, Doc Ox's arms.
Do you think the final fight should be longer?
It was kind of long, but like I said before, I just thought there should have been like one more fight in the series.
So upcoming villains are Electro, Vulture, Doc Ock.
In the sinister, they go out and in. It depends what it is.
Like no, but from what I saw from the from the vault.
Yeah.
Vulture, Doc Ock, Electro, Green Goblin.
Green Goblin, yes, was a part
Black
of it.
Cat, and Rhino.
Yeah.
So, those are the six villains that I really think
ooh,
are going to
this
yeah, be in the Sinister
Six.
Well, my question is, they didn't announce...
Oh, that's six villains right there, Sinister Six.
Yes, that's what I mean. My question is, are they going to do a Sinister Six move before the third one comes out? Or is it probably going to be played after, towards the movie is...
okay, I'm going to die.
Done. So are you going to see like 2017, for example?
What I really want is Spider-Man with X-Men or Avengers with...
That's what we thought that credit sequence was at the end. Yeah. It's like, oh, X-Men crossover? What is this? What the heck is this? Did you guys see that? That little... That was physics right there.
But what I really want is a crossover in the actual universe.
Yeah.
Ah!
Yeah, that's, Avengers. I want to see him in Avengers. But God knows we won't see him for that. People are saying the third one he might have a shot now. Because they're doing licensing agreements and all that. But who knows at this point.
How do I beat this woman?
Yeah. Really? Yeah. Okay, say something. According to Blah, this is the longest Spider-Man movie. The second Amazing Spider-Man.
It was pretty long.
It did feel kind of long,
142
minutes.
But not in a bad way.
Yeah, not in a bad way. I felt the middle kind of, at times, dragged on a bit, but besides that...
if we're talking about a movie that did that, the Avengers... was it the second Avengers?
There's not even a second one out yet.
The first one.
Next year.
So, the Avengers, in the first half of the Avengers, was so drawn out and boring, I wanted to kill myself. And then in the second half, it was amazing, I totally forgot about the first half.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
No, certain parts of the first half I liked.
In the first half of the Avengers, I wanted to kill myself.
There was a lot of talking. Granted, I understood, like, they had to work together and, like, I mean, fight because no one got along. But I'd rather have that through action, like the Iron Man, Thor, and,
Loki.
What am I supposed to do here?
And then Captain America is like the
seriously,
Boy Scout interruption.
Yeah,
we're getting way off topic though. But yeah, I know what you're talking about.
So Amazing Spider-Man 2.
Avengers, Star Wars, Batman. Did we talk about, I don't know, what else? Captain America 2, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Captain America 2, though, if you watch the Ant-Man, I'm not going to say any spoilers for that one. It's definitely, in terms of, it had the perfect amount of action, storytelling,
This is a spoiler, but I really want to say this. Something I hated about Captain America 2, when they hailed Hydra, they didn't do, if you're a comic book reader, you know what I'm talking about, when they put their two arms up. So it's like when you hail Hitler, you put one arm up and open.
Below's playing right now.
When you hail,
Below is playing now.
Hail Hydra is closed fists for both hands and up in the air.
Yes.
And they didn't do that in the Captain America.
But they created a meme from doing that.
Which was a hug and then a Hail Hydra whisper. Which was hilarious, granted. because now I'm going to walk up to everyone, hug them and say Hail Hydra.
Yeah.
But I really
Chris
hated,
will just, select to skip them.
I really hated how they didn't put the two arms up in Hail Hydra in the movie.
Well, you can't win them all, I guess.
Yeah, that's true.
Maybe they're trying to make a new thing.
No, I think they're just trying to avoid the Hitler stigma.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, it's kind of difficult to do when it's Captain America.
Yeah, it is, definitely. Yeah. So anything else we really got to talk about Amazing Spider-Man 2 or our overall thoughts, I guess?
It was really good.
I don't know how to...
I enjoyed it. I think they didn't do anything bad except the Peter Parker thing with the Peter Parker's parents.
Yeah. I do not like that aspect of it. It's just kind of uninteresting. It's not like bad, but it's uninteresting.
They didn't do anything bad, but... They could have done a lot of things better. Yeah. But it was a good movie. I liked it.
It was definitely better than the first one, in my opinion. Like, I would say go watch it. Yes. Like, the only reason I say go watch the first Amazing Spider-Man is so you can understand the events of this one.
But all I'm going to say...
Wow, you lasted...
I don't know. My closing thoughts are...
Why is it so sweaty?
No, he asked... Yeah, I asked him.
My closing thoughts are go watch it. It was a good movie.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Especially in 3D. Oh my god, the visuals in 3D.
I don't think it'll make that much...
It doesn't make that much of a difference.
During the movie...
The swinging sections do, though.
During the movie, I thought the glasses wouldn't fit on my face. Because I wear glasses, so my old glasses with the 3D glasses hurt a lot. So I used to pop out the lens and put it into my glasses, and that would work. These glasses fit comfortably, but I forgot that I have new glasses.
How are we talking about glasses?
Because, you know, 3D glasses, you know.
Okay. To cut a long story short, I popped out one of the lenses, and I'm like, this doesn't fit.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, didn't you see
it? Dude, I had to go through this. He's like, can I have your glasses now? I'm like, no? Are you serious?
I popped out one of the lenses, and I'm like, wait. This doesn't fit. Yeah. And then I was basically watching half 3D, half 2D.
Mm-hmm. Well, you got both the experiences. Okay.
I got both the experiences. So I can comment, comment that there was a slight difference.
Oh,
you watched the PD movie.
Actually, to be completely honest, there was no 3D in that movie.
Like, there wasn't that much,
It wasn't very 3D.
Ish.
But the 3D gave the visuals more realism.
Yes.
Yeah.
If you're going to watch something and want to watch it in 3D, it's not going to be 3D.
I don't know.
But it's going to make the visuals nicer.
Yes. If you're one of those people that are like graphics poor.
I definitely like I recommend it because Electro was just
really
good. Electro was really good.
Yeah.
Green Goblin was really good. Yeah. I really liked it.
Yes. And then that Rhino scene with the kid was
Good. Yeah, it was good. Granted, the trailers were definitely misleading. They show a lot of scenes at the end that
We actually went into the movie thinking Rhino was gonna be like one of
You're the big villain.
Yeah.
He was in the beginning, but as like the ordinary thug, and I understand how they had to show that at first because that is true.
But they took way too long to make like his transformation.
Yeah, but the end, it made for a good ending. Making Spider-Man feel guilty.
Granted, Rhino didn't really have a transformation.
What's up?
Was just recruited, you know?
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Hey, yo, dude, you thug over there.
Uh-huh.
Come here, wear this suit and kill people.
I know,
it was basically that.
He was broken out of jail, actually.
Yes, I know, but, like, still, I mean, it wasn't really, like...
I think she's
We don't really know who Rhino is.
Is she right under you? Check right under you. Under.
Also, Rhino is actually... Rhino actually has titanium-fused skin.
Yeah, the suit. Oh, yeah, what do you feel about the suit?
What do you feel about the suit?
I hated the aspect at first. When I saw it in motion though, it kind of made me, you know, change thoughts.
Rhino had machine guns.
Yeah,
Rhino does not have
also keep in mind, though, that the robotic suit is from the Ultimate series. However, they call it the Amazing Spider-Man, not the Ultimate Spider-Man. So, you know. I didn't hate it, though. It looked good.
It was all right.
Oh, I thought I didn't hate it.
I didn't hate it.
But I would have much rather had an original Rhino.
Yeah, in fact, in this game, they have something like that.
I would have much rather had the original Rhino interpretation, but I didn't hate it.
Yeah, I didn't hate it.
Oh, it's cool.
If you wanted to, if you wanted to put a twist on it and, like, doing the ultimate spin on it, it was pretty good.
Yeah.
Granted, it was only for like a few short seconds. I mean, we're talking about this like it was like the main like bulk of the movie.
Yeah.
It's really not. It's like
trailers,
it's like at most 2 minutes.
The trailers are incredibly misleading.
Yeah, when I see the Amazing Spider-Man 3 trailer, I'm gonna be like, okay, this is the stuff we're gonna see at the end.
Yeah. If you're going in there thinking that the trailers are what you're gonna see, they're not.
Mm-hmm. They're not. Not to say that the movie wasn't good. No, definitely not.
The trailer showed the movie as it was going to be uninteresting. I don't know, closing remarks by anyone?
Go watch this movie.
It's not like, oh my, like, fantabulous, though. Like, it's not like, in my opinion, it's not like The Dark Knight.
It's definitely a good way to spend a weekend.
Yes, definitely, Yes. We watched it, as we said, two days ago. We would have done this, as we said before, like, the opening night.
Adnan's fault.
Yes. Or
how?
And Below was like, yeah, but
I told you guys a bus
stop. Hey, shut up!
Okay,
you messed it up.
It's not my fault you guys missed the bus.
Anyway.
Yes.
I guess that's a consensus of you should go watch it.
I liked it better than the first one. I don't like it better than the original Spider-Man 2, in my opinion.
All feminists are gonna go, you know, crazy because you just hit a girl.
Wait, what?
Yeah. Yaya's about to do the most sexist rant. Well, not. It's not sexist. Okay. But females who are watching this, you'll be pissed. I'm sorry, Will.
Okay. There's this whole thing that's going on. They did the casting for Star Wars recently. And
this is the perfect scene for this.
They did the casting for Star Wars recently, and some feminists were really mad for some reason because apparently the casting didn't include enough women. Now, the problem I have with this is that the casting was split up into two categories. The first part was original cast, which you can't change. And the second part was new cast. The new cast was basically 50-50 male to female ratio. I really don't see any problem that the women should have had with this. They were being incredibly, incredibly butthurt. And I think they should stick their opinions where the sun doesn't shine and just let the directors direct this movie. They were totally not in the right on this.
Well, that's been Yaya's rant of the day. But still, to go on the closing thoughts about Amazing Spider-Man 2, I thought it was way better than the first. Definitely go see it.
Bilal is really enjoying this scene for obvious reasons.
Yeah, I know, right? It looks swingy.
Close-up.
Yeah, blah. Oh, dang it. Yay! White fading in.
Censored!
That's the best I can do, guys.
Censored.
Okay. And they're having a little chat. I'm definitely pumped up to see the third one, like the first movie. So you still say, though, that you like the first Amazing Spider-Man better than the second, though? What the heck?
I don't know.
A bunch of rubble.
Don't
be like the people on the internet who are changed so easily just because someone else likes something else. If you like the first one, go ahead. You know, screw the people that are like, you're dumb for having an opinion.
Exactly.
Screw your people if you're watching. I don't give a crap.
I like both of them. To be honest.
Yeah, you like both of them, yeah.
Okay.
But yeah, go watch it. I feel like every time I see any comments on YouTube or just any rants or blogs, people are so, either they love it or they hate it. That's all I see. I never see a middle ground. For me, I'm on the middle ground when it comes to the first one, but I thought the second one is pretty good. Definitely better than Spider-Man 3. There's no competition there.
Like I said, the Phantom Menace of the Spider-Man series.
Yes, but in that case, that's Yaya's wet dream, you know?
Apparently people have a problem with my opinion.
Yes.
I'm good with it. I've had this experience before.
Okay, thank you for joining us. This has been Adnan Siddiqui.
Even though, Adnan, you weren't, like, the main host here.
I know, right?
But I guess I'll close it off. Bilal, you might want to say, you might as well say your name.
Well, I'm Bilal.
Thank you.
Do you want the people to know who? Blow. You want to do your little shameless plug in here,
the website?
Yes, yeah, you might as well go ahead.
I have a website. That you can get clothes. There's some clothes that are related to games, and you could tweet me if you want customized clothes at the Blood Show.
Touch back again.
That's wanker. Ooh, that's dirty.
Do you think so? Well, I better not show you where the lemonade is. Sweet lemon.
With that random moment of singing aside, thank you for joining us on this random bunch of ideas and thoughts. Yes, about this was very unprofessional. We are aware of this. We are reviewers.
Yes.
Speaking of which, now would be the perfect time to do the channel update before I close. First of all, we're not dead just because we don't upload a video in about 2 weeks.
We've just been having like exams and stuff.
Yeah, we've been really busy. I've been switching jobs and stuff. Yeah. You know, Bilal's been busy, you know, jacking off to Emma Stone pictures before the releases. Okay. The upload schedule as soon as this is posted is that we already recorded parts of New Super Mario Bros. So they'll be uploaded throughout the week, and it'll go back-to-back with my LP of both Lost World and Final Fantasy X, both which aren't canceled, by the way. It's just a little bit of a break because I've been busy. So they'll be back-to-back, as I said. Like, for example, this Wednesday, for example, New Super Mario Bros. 2 will be... New Super Mario Bros. 2. The part 5 of New Super Mario Bros. Will be uploaded. Then on Friday, Final Fantasy X. And then on Sunday, for example, will be New Super Mario... You get the picture. And also, while we're saying talking about co-op playthroughs, unfortunately, we have to cancel Mario and Sonic at the Winter Olympic Games.
I'm tearing up.
Due to audio issues... For those who watched part 3 of New Super Mario Bros., there was like about a 30-second moment where the audio was messed up. And unfortunately, for large portions of the later parts of the playthrough of Mario and Sonic, it got cut off, therefore making it very, very awkward. And granted, we could maybe post the highlights up one day, but we feel that we'll most likely just return to it during an appropriate time, like in the winter. Well, we'll definitely do probably Mario and Sonic at the Olympic Games, like the Beijing games, and other co-op games. We're going to go outside of Mario and Sonic very, very soon. However, there's a very special game we'll be doing at the very end of this month, a new one that everyone's definitely hyped up for Wii U owners. However, we're not going to spoil it.
50 Shades of Grey.
Yes.
Wii U edition.
We're gonna do one other game before that just to hype up the week before. So look forward to that. On behalf of myself and also the group here, we want to apologize for the lack of uploads. It's just been busy. However, now we're gonna be kicking it back in gear. Also, granted, I generally don't say stuff like this, but leave a comment if you liked something like this, because we can do something like this with X-Men or the new Star Wars. We definitely have to do it the day it does come out, just so we can hear Yaya rant. We're about the feminists. But yeah, please leave your thoughts. Also, your thoughts about the movie as well, because we like to see opinions of both your thoughts on the movies in general. So far. But I had a fun time. Sorry for the lack of skill in The Amazing Spider-Man.
Happy Star Wars Day, and may the Force be with you.
Yes. The best day to do this is May the 4th.
Oh, and could someone please may start like a rant in the comics? Because I'll totally I'll totally join in.
For what? The 5 minute?
No, for anything.
Start. Yeah, someone start a freaking rant. Yes, please. Yes, we want to like just pause YouTube.
Give me something to fight in. I enjoy internet battles. Yes.
I think that about wraps it up. But I guess we might as well close off. Bilal, why don't you start? Because you said the least. And any statement you just want to say about anything in general.
I like the movies.
You don't want to say anything about
what?
Shameless plug in? No.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Gwen Stacy.
She's
hot.
Yeah.
She's hot.
Yeah, she's pretty
She's
good.
Your like, wallpaper.
Yes.
Okay.
No, actually,
she's
Demi Lovato.
Oh, no, Demi Lovato. True love right there. And true fan.
Not true fan of Spider-Man.
But we all got the collector's cups for the freaking Spider-Man.
No, but I got the cool straw. My straw has... Can you edit in a picture?
We're going to edit the picture in, right? We got the freaking lame versions on the straw with the bobblehead, like, Spider-Man face. And you got the, like, action figure, like, full body Spider-Man.
No, I'm going to go watch the movie again.
Oh, yes, that's true fan right there. Oh, that's true. That's even truer. He got the lame version. And are you gonna like rival that?
I don't know. I might just have to buy every cup there. Yeah, just to make sure he doesn't.
I even go to Iron Man collector's cup too.
I'm not true Iron Man fan.
Iron Man 3 sucked.
No, shut up, Yaya. Before we get into another rant, we might talk about this some other time. Like, our thoughts about the Iron Man movie.
Iron Man 3 did suck.
Shut up. What,
the entire suit thing at the end was
I liked
terrible.
It. I thought Iron Man 2 sucked. Iron Man 2 sucked, but Iron Man 3 was good.
Mandarin would
Iron Man's enemy, and they destroyed him. We'll save this rant for another time. Please, if you want to see our rants, please comment about that. But anyways, yes, I plan to see Amazing Spider-Man 2 because I usually do, again, with my father, because we usually have do that with all the movies, the Spider-Man movies. So any other thoughts that I have about the movies, I'll leave in the comments. And likewise, you guys, if you want to say anything else that we missed in this video, which is probable due to being distracted by various things.
The fact that Spider-Man, I mean, no, Iron Man 2 and 3 suck.
This is Yahya Ismail.
3 was signing good, off. But there were some weird aspects of it.
Well, goodbye.
You gotta agree
that okay, and last... shut up, okay? Yes, okay. And it was kind of like The Incredibles, Iron Man 3.
Like the yeah, exactly.
Okay, okay, I mean,
especially
but,
that one okay, scene I where the, I hope where the nerd meets Iron Man.
Yeah, anyways, and then you
way,
say...
I signed off already. You guys may want to follow suit.
Well, that's the lame way. You whispered into... You did the silent ear rape. Gannon, anything else left to say?
I just, like, watch this movie. It's a really good movie. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's plain and simple, eh?
Yeah, I know, right? Yeah, no, nothing yeah, much yeah. to say. We covered everything.
Yeah. Amazing Spider-Man 2, big leap from the original movie. I can't say it'll please everyone, because I've been seeing some people that
say... That's hope they don't destroy it in the third and fourth.
Yes. I can't say everyone will be pleased, because I've been seeing critics and also fans as well saying that they hate it. And I can understand some points, and that's okay. Everyone has opinion. You know, like they say, opinions are like assholes. Exactly. Everyone has one, and think everyone else stinks. You know?
No, I think the saying goes, opinions are like assholes. Everyone has one, but Yahya's is the best. Yeah.
No one would know that because no one wants to venture that deep.
All right. Yes.
But yes,
no one wants to prove that point.
Anyways, this is Brand the Random Gamer. The next upload you'll see is another commentary. Sorry for the delay. Hope you enjoyed this video.
Take care. Happy Star Wars Day.
And goodbye.
See ya.